ordered that it be halted, and everyone was still presenting a 215 renewal as de facto approval for its continuation. Without even that renewal, it is hard to envision the administration justifying its continuation at all. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Ireland's government minister said voters overwhelmingly approved a measure to allow civil same-sex marriage, making it the first nation in the world to legalize gay unions through a popular vote. Campaigners on both sides of the debate said a victory was imminent. Those who opposed the amendment to the country's constitution to allow same-sex marriage conceded defeat in the heavily Roman Catholic country. David Quinn, the director of the conservative Iona Institute that was leading the charge against the referendum, tweeted a congratulatory message. He later said, despite the victory, we will continue to affirm the importance of the biological ties and of motherhood and fatherhood. He said, we believe we fought a good campaign. It was always going to be an uphill battle. However, we helped provide a voice to the hundreds of thousands of Irish people who did vote no. The fact that no political party supported them must be a concern from a democratic point of view.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a Cleveland police officer was found not guilty on Saturday in the shooting deaths of an unarmed man and woman after a high-speed car chase in 2012, one in a series of cases that have raised questions about police conduct and race relations in the United States. Judge John O'Donnell said Officer Michael Brillo acted responsibly in shooting the two suspects while standing on the hood of their surrounded car and firing multiple rounds through the windshield. Brillo, who was among a group of officers who fired on the car, was found not guilty of voluntary manslaughter and aggravated assault. O'Donnell said during the roughly half-hour-long reading of the verdict, Brillo was acting in conditions difficult for even experienced officers to imagine. A small crowd of demonstrators took to the streets to protest the verdict, chanting, "No justice, no peace." This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
College roommates continue their bonding process until real friends are made, and a teacher hopes they never Google him. It's time for the weekly video feature that's heartier and more comforting than a heaping bowl of mom's butternut squash soup. This is the Onion Week in Review. Longtime James F. Blaine Elementary School teacher Suzanne Pomponio told reporters today that she could not believe how much fatter her second graders are getting. Pomponio estimates that each and every one of her kids must be 8 to 10 pounds heavier than anyone in her 2011 class, adding, quote, "and those kids were pretty fat too."
Honestly, I didn't think it was possible that this year's kids could be fatter than last year's, but they are. I mean, short kids are fat, tall kids are fat, and there's a smell. I don't really know how to describe it.
Local dad Michael Corain navigated several discount travel websites today with a precision reminiscent of 18th century Viennese prodigy Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart composing a symphony.
This is the Onion News Network.
Credit?
Free Talk Live, you may join us here for this live Sunday edition of the program. The Us Tonight is me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
We've got a website. You can go to freetalklive.com, get interactive there, completely free. You can also call us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Lots to talk about tonight here, including a story I've been kind of holding on to for a few days about pop music in the United States and how dumb the lyrics are. Apparently, the intelligence quotient of the lyrics to pop music has been getting worse over time.
Okay.
And what does that mean? Well, we can talk more about that on the way here. But we've been following also the story of Liberland as well here on Free Talk Live, because I'm just absolutely fascinated by any movement of people who are trying to achieve more freedom. I like that. That's why we moved, Mark, you and I, and hundreds and now over 1,700, I think, or 1,500 other people have moved here to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. The Free State Project being the arguably most successful of all political migrations in our lifetime, at least as far as, you know, that I'm aware of, for freedom at least. You go to freestateproject.org, you can learn more about that. But the basic idea of the Free State Project is to concentrate activists who care about freedom in one area. People who understand what liberty means, that, you know, you should be free to live your life how you want, so long as you don't harm anyone else in the process, so long as you don't use aggressive force against others. And people that understand that are getting together here in New Hampshire. New Hampshire was chosen out of 10 possible states in a vote of around 5,000 possible people. I think over 2,000 people voted in that. I don't know if you want to call it an election choice, I suppose, choosing the state, the destination. New Hampshire has since had over 1,500 people move to it as part of the Free State Project. We have over 16,000 people who've pledged to make the move here to New Hampshire. And it is a very successful movement thus far. There have been people been elected here as both Republicans and Democrats who are
by far the most successful sort of liberty-oriented move here project, far and removed.
There are a bunch of them too. There are many have fizzled.
Historically there are a bunch of them. Yes,
right. And many of them, most of them have fizzled and failed completely. Others are kind of barely hanging on, subsisting. Most of them don't, you know, they're just not there. You've even made a Facebook page, Mark, called the Move Here Project, and I presume you've put Liberland on that Facebook page?
You know, I don't know if Liberland's made it. I haven't updated the page in a while because it's sort of a historical page. It's not like, here's new and interesting facts. I mean, I guess...
Well, no, but you've been adding new Move Here projects as they've come out. At least that's my understanding.
It should be on there. That's for certain.
So Liberland is kind of the newest of all of these projects, and Liberland is a plot of land about 3 square miles that is in between, was it Bosnia and Serbia?
Serbia and Croatia.
Serbia and Croatia, thank you. In between Serbia and Croatia, and it is sort of was thought to be a no man's land as far as both Serbia and Croatia were not interested in this particular plot of land. And so that's why the president of Liberland selected this location. His name is Vit Jedlica, and we're going to talk a little bit more about him because there's an update here from their website, which is, I don't know if it's their site, it's related, liberlandpress.com, about Liberland's first settlers, the LSA, the Liberland Settlement Association. And Liberland blew up earlier, I don't know, like a month ago, maybe a month and a half. It's not very long ago. It hit the news. There was this press release Liberland sent out. They were basically like a Facebook page at that time, and I guess they had a website, but it went big on social media. It went big in mainstream media. There were all kinds of headlines everywhere about this, and recently, the most recent news is that members of Liberland have been arrested for trying to go to this plot of land, and apparently, it is the Croatian government that is doing the cracking down. They are the ones who are doing the arresting. You can apparently more easily get in from the Serbian side of Liberland, and this is a location that is very nearby the Danube River. And Mark, you have poked fun at this, saying that it is a swamp, but the early movers here are saying it is absolutely beautiful. According to liberlandpress.com, this is an article about their Liberland Settlement Association. In recent weeks, the government of Liberland has made several references on its social media accounts about a mysterious group known as the Liberland Settlement Association, which has left many wondering just what the LSA is and what role it plays in the development of Liberland. Niklas Nikoljason.
We shouldn't be, assigned the task of pronouncing Baltic names.
We'll call him Niklas. Yeah. I can get the first name there. We are the boots on the ground in Liberland, he says. We are dedicated to bringing freedom and sovereignty to Liberland and to creating a permanent settlement there as soon as possible.
It's interesting.
Indeed, the group has already settled into a temporary campsite in nearby Serbia, where they're using that as a base of operations while they wait for the day when they can move into Liberland permanently. For all of the many requests that the Liberland government has made for people to join them on the ground, it seems clear that nobody has answered those calls more consistently than the LSA. And the article does have pictures here of LSA members that are exploring the Liberland property. The LSA started within days after President Vit Jedlicka dug his flag into Liberland soil. A group of libertarian-leaning Swiss had taken notice and began a Facebook page to discuss the many possibilities of the new European nation.
Interesting.
Before too long, they were joined by friends and then friends of friends who shared similar beliefs and interests. The group sent three of its members to Liberland to scout the land, which they were successfully able to do since at that time the Croatian police were not yet occupying it. So apparently, according to the news stories we'd read previously, the Croatian cops and the border patrol, or whoever they are, decided to start patrolling the border between Liberland and Croatia after the Liberland settlement folks started to try to get on to the property.
Yeah, I mean, they probably just don't like that idea, free and stuff.
Yeah, all of a sudden they're taking an interest in this, whereas previously they had not had one.
Right, and they have no, so there's court cases here, but it's going to be interesting. What's going to happen when you, as the executive branch, bring charges against some people for attempting to enter, attempting to be in some place that you have no legal authority
right? Over?
There's no, it's not their jurisdiction.
So by the time the scouting exhibition team arrived back home, they had reached some clear conclusions. Liberland is strikingly beautiful, and it would be well worth the time and effort to stake a claim of some of its land. The group sprang into action to create an official Swiss-based nonprofit entity, and the LSA was officially born. Much has happened since that time. For one thing, a number of LSA members have relocated to the area permanently and are working towards the association's goals day in and day out. Their campsite is impressively equipped with two full-size Swiss Army tents, two Army-powered generators, an LSA-built shower, and plenty more.
Call me a bigot, but if I have somebody doing a setup here, I'd love it to be the Swiss. I expect it to be efficient and precise if they're doing it.
Does that have something to do with like their Swiss Army knife? Like, are they known for being an efficient and precise people?
Yeah, they are.
Okay.
They're also known for their clocks and their chocolate.
The group has even acquired its own vehicle, a used Land Rover recently purchased in Serbia. Not everything has gone smoothly for the LSA, however.
Is that the Liberland Army? The Land Rover?
Oh, I don't know. Not everything has gone smoothly for the LSA. On May 11th, six LSA members were arrested and charged with an illegal border crossing after crossing by foot from Croatia into Liberland. The group was released the next morning after being warned that one may only leave Croatia at an official border crossing. Okay. So you have to go through their official location in order to leave the country.
Yep, that makes perfect sense to me. I mean, that's how governments are. That isn't particularly surprising. They want you to be at their spots. If I were to attempt to enter Canada, they'd be pretty upset if I didn't go through one of their little spots.
That's true. The group was released the next morning after being warned that, in spirit of the respecting the laws of the neighboring countries, President Jedlicka, along with several members of the LSA, later decided to enter Liberland by international waterway instead. Unfortunately, the boat ride resulted in more arrests, though this time the charges were questionable at best and the group plans to appeal the court's ruling. At any rate, spending the night in jail with a head of state is not an everyday experience for most, but an experience recently enjoyed by some members of the LSA. Thankfully, risk-taking is not mandatory, as the LSA mentions in its recruitment material. Quote, no one will be forced to put themselves directly at risk by challenging the Croatian authorities, but some of us must, as it is the only way to secure a free and sovereign Liberland.
That's a true statement.
Setting freedom fighting aside, it does seem the LSA also excels at having fun. The president recently posed for a photo shoot while joining LSA members at their newly made on-site bar. Tell you a little bit more about what's happening in Liberland, and you can share your thoughts with us. Plus, is music being dumbed down? We'll look into that as well here tonight on the live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. Our number is 855-450-FREE.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results?
It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
A new report released this week has found that nearly three-quarters of sleepaway campers' parents are currently using their children's time away from home to take the first steps towards filing for divorce.
With 46% of campers' moms currently staying with their sisters while they try to figure it out, and 38% of campers' dads sleeping on the living room couch and staring at the ceiling for hours before falling asleep.
Most campers are, at this precise moment, wholly unaware that their fathers are looking for temporary sublets and are experiencing a level of carefree, joyful buoyancy that experts say they will never feel again.
The majority of campers currently have, on average, 16 days until their lives come crashing down around them, at which point their parents will pick them up from camp, drive them to a restaurant, and then break the news that while they'll always be a family, they won't be living together anymore.
I love camp this year. It's so much fun. Mom sent me so many care packages. Dad even sent one. It's awesome.
This is the Onion News Network.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here toll free, 855-450-FREE. Are you ready to make the move to Liberland? Well, there are a number of people who are currently staging on the Serbian side of the border, preparing to make the move over there. They say they're there permanently. These guys are serious. They're calling themselves the LSA, the Liberland Settlement Association. This is a three square mile plot of land between Croatia and Serbia. The Croatian government, however, has not been friendly toward the settlers. They have been basically arresting them for trying to cross the border at an unapproved border location. And even when they tried to come in through the international waterway, they were arrested, apparently, for that. So how are you supposed to get to this place?
I don't know. The authorities, I can understand why they don't want necessarily. Generally, countries don't like new countries.
Yeah, for sure.
It's not always true, but it
is. It's new competition.
Generally
true.
There was a situation where I can't remember exactly what happened. I read the story not too long ago. Caspia or something like that. It was a plot of land between the Papal States and Florence. And essentially, it had no ruler for 150 years or something like that. And everybody's like, you know, this is pretty cool. And they could do what they wanted there. They didn't have all the restrictions that these governments with state heads had. So, you know, they could exist. And you know, obviously, the Papal States in Florence found this a benefit to have somebody who's sort of in between and not their big rival. So it could be possible that this could be a good thing, that, you know, Croatia or Serbia could, you know, see a benefit here. It looks like Serbia does see a benefit. Here's the benefit. Croatia looks like a bunch of a-holes arresting some people who want to go to an island in the middle of the Danube. Mm. And, you know, like, I used to have... I guess you think things about certain countries, right? Obviously, this is just a collection of people. But you have some conclusions about them. For whatever reason, my conclusions about Serbia tended to be worse than my conclusions about Croatia.
Previously.
Mm-hmm. I have new conclusions. It's now that, you know, these are obvious generalizations, and I shouldn't think this way at all, but, you know, humans think in groups. And so now my thoughts are, wow, Croatians a bunch of a-holes, and Serbia's not so bad.
What's interesting, and we're going to continue with more about Liberland here in moments.
Yeah, a lot of talk about liberty is going to be held at Freedom Fest. This is the largest gathering of free minds in the world, has been for some time. It's going on from July the 8th to the 11th this year, Planet Hollywood in Las Vegas. So I'm going to be heading to Freedom Fest, and I urge you to join me at the world's best liberty conference. Discover the New American Dream is what the title is this year, and it's going to be bigger and better than ever because they're having the historic dream debate of the century. Paul Krugman versus Steve Moore. Steve Moore is the Wall Street Journal columnist and chief economist for the Heritage Foundation. Paul Krugman is the Nobel Prize winning economist and New York Times columnist. And they're going to debate austerity versus stimulus, red state versus blue state, flat tax versus progressive tax. This is only happening at Freedom Fest. There's going to be a lot of big names there. There always are. John Mackey, CEO of Whole Foods, Steve Wynn, Peter Thiel, just a whole bunch of them. Dinesh D'Souza, Grover Norquist, Congressman Alan West, Glenn Beck. Going to be no shortage of famous liberty-type folks there. And you can come check it out with me. Just go to freedomfest.com, buy your ticket. When you do, please check that you heard on the radio. That's the way we get the credit for it. Or if you give them a call, mention Free Talk Live, if you would, please. Come on out, hang out with me. It's going to be a great event. I'll be right there on Radio Row. You can come by, say hi. You know, if you're in, you know, we don't do that many events out west. So if you're out west, consider, it's Vegas. It's not like you're going to have a bad time. freedomfest.com. July the 8th through the 11th, Planet Hollywood in Las Vegas. You can give them a call at 855-850-FREE. It's 855-850-FREE, freedomfest.com.
So apparently over at Liberland, they've now had three what they call weekend parties over there, and they've been apparently meeting up. There's an event on Facebook where they'll meet up at a meeting point in Serbia, Karda Kod Karin, and then I don't know if they're actually going to Liberland or not. I'm not really clear on that.
Okay.
It is a party happening near the location of Liberland. I don't know if they're still, you know, if they've got the gumption to keep trying to go back there from the Serbian side.
I'd sure want to go if I was there. If I was at that party and it was close,
you'd want to go.
I'd want to go.
Especially after getting liquored up.
Yeah. Let's take me to this land, that you know, this 3 square miles that you people claim is unclaimed by any country.
So I wonder if the you know, if they were to go in from the Serbian end of things and mm-hmm. go into Liberland, would the Croatian guards or the cops, border guards, would they come into Liberland? Would they then trespass, if you will, into the territory and arrest people who didn't even go from their side?
Got me.
That's not made clear. I haven't really understood how that works out exactly and how much time is really being spent in Liberland. But we are talking about the Liberland Settlement Association, who in their recruiting material does point out that they're not requiring anyone to put themselves directly at risk by challenging the Croatian authorities, but that they are willing to, some of them are willing to challenge and to take this to court. So, plus they've been having fun. They've got an on-site bar at their camp in Serbia. The atmosphere around the LSA camp is clearly one of adventure and fun, with the side benefit of working for a cause. This, according to LiberlandPress.com. If this sounds like an ideal place to be, it just so happens the LSA is seeking more people to join their group. Quote, "What we need most are settlers and activists," says their founder. Come join the fight for Liberland's independence and help us settle. The LSA provides all members food and drink, along with a place to camp while on site.
I see. That's a pretty big deal.
Yeah, that is a big deal. Seems like it's well-funded.
Yeah.
Additional support and
if
perks.
If you're just looking for warm bodies, you'll get them.
Additional support and perks are
offered. Not always that great to hang out with, but you'll get them.
Especially, they're offering perks, they say, especially to those who stay the longest. Liberland has received over 300,000 applications for citizenship. When we first read the story about Liberland, it was within the first week. They had 30,000 or so within the first several days. Now 300,000 applications for citizenship. But as of now, the government has only awarded citizenship to those who are directly working to make Liberland a reality, including several LSA members. For those who want to help in the early formation of this exciting new country, the Liberland Settlement Association appears to be the most hands-on way to get involved.
When are we going, Ian?
For more information, the LSA can be reached via email at info@liberlandsa.org. When are we going? Well, you know what? I actually am going to the plan during Porkfest is to try to use my world passport up at the Canadian border to see if I can get across. Of course, I also have misdemeanors on my record, so I don't know if that'll prevent
Shouldn't
me from getting across. I've heard that they won't let you into Canada if you have a criminal record.
If you have, generally, it's felonies.
Really?
Generally.
But I've heard there are some misdemeanors that they won't let you
right,
in for,
Right, you haven't hit anybody. That's probably going
to
be an issue.
I haven't hit anybody, but I've committed one of the greatest crimes known to governments, which is disobedience. Obstructing government administration. I mean, that's taken pretty seriously.
Well, we'll see.
Yeah, I guess so. So anyway, yeah, I don't really have any plan to do any other international travel at this time, Mark, but I am interested in watching to see what happens there in Liberland, and maybe if they're so well-funded, they can hire you to remote broadcast out there.
I should give them a call.
Get you a satellite phone or something like that. I wonder if it's outside of, like, 3G. You know, is Liberland near any Serbian or Croatian city?
I don't see
why
you couldn't put up your own tower there. I bet you could get some cell company to give you some kind of booster.
That'd be interesting. 855-450-FREE. We'll keep you in the loop on Liberland. Plus, coming up, dumbing down music. It's apparently getting worse over time. That is the average age range or grade level of the wording used for these songs. We'll tell you more about that coming up. You can share your thoughts as well. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering from EP? The symptoms include fraudulent charges to your credit card. Your subway card says it's empty, but you bought it yesterday. Someone's been in your hotel room, but the desk clerk says they only show you entering the room. These are signs of EP, electronic pickpocketing. Payment cards, transit cards, even hotel room keys use a radio chip, so you can just wave your card at the register, the turnstile, or your hotel room door. But what's convenient for you is also convenient for thieves, waving scanners to electronically pickpocket you without even touching you. The good news is there's a cure. ID Stronghold has created leather wallets and clutches that have built-in EP protection. Layers of shielding material cleverly concealed in a beautiful leather wallet that stops the symptoms of EP. Go to IDStronghold.com now and get the cure. IDStronghold.com. Warning, ID Stronghold wallets could lead to feelings of safety and security, comfort in crowds, and euphoria. If you experience these emotions, immediately inform your friends and family about IDStronghold.com so they can feel better too.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. You may join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE, whether you want to talk about Liberland or whatever happens to be on your mind coming up, pop music, lyrics, and are, if you couldn't imagine, they are becoming more vapid than they've ever been in the past. We will share that with you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. It's the live Sunday edition. You can also bring up anything you want. That is the reason we call the show Free Talk Live. And you can join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm.
Fort Galt, if you're looking to travel to be freer, maybe Liberland's for you. Maybe it's not. Maybe Chile might be a better destination. What they're doing down in Chile, Fort Galt, what they're doing is they're building this condominium complex that's intended to, you know, you buy a room basically to sleep in, and they've got these common areas that what they're looking for is entrepreneurs, small business owners, freelancers, young professionals, and their families to sort of collaborate and create something new and special there. I think it's a very interesting project. Check them out at fortgalt.com. You will not be disappointed. They have great videos and a great website. This is, you know, well done, very, very well done. And I think you're going to be as impressed as I was. Go to fortgalt.com. There isn't some kind of big outlay as far as money goes. Basically, you sign up and then you pay as they succeed, as they create the stuff. You know, little payouts as time goes by. So it's fortgalt.com, and it might be the community you've always dreamt of. Fortgalt.com. It's spelled F-O-R-T-G-A-L-T, as in John Galt. Fortgalt.com.
All right, our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Story is over at Antimedia, theantimedia.org. A recent study served to confirm the patently obvious. Song lyrics for the most popular genres of music are ridiculously obtuse and getting worse over time. Though this may not be a revelation, the figures are distressing indicators of both an intellectually vapid societal and cultural future, as well as its apparent inevitability. If you've already moved away from Billboard music, congratulations, you refuse to be insulted. But if you haven't, or if you're concerned about pop culture trends acting as portents of systemic dysfunction, you should probably pay attention. Andrew Powell Morse of SeatSmart studied the lyric intelligence of 225 Billboard songs in the pop, country, hip-hop, and rock genres that spent 3 or more weeks parked at the top of the charts. To analyze any changes.
So these are the real hits.
That's correct. To analyze any changes over the course of 10 years. And change there was. 10 years ago, the most popular songs read between a third and fourth grade level. But the inanity only increased with time. And after a 5-year downward tumble ending in 2014, which was the last year of the study, chart-topping hits had a reading level equivalent to second or third grade. Broken into genres, the levels measure just 2.6, that is grades, 2.6 grade for hip-hop/R&B, a tie of 2.9 for both rock and pop, and faring best was country at 3.3.
I don't even really even understand what they mean as far as a reading level. You don't read songs.
Well, that's what they are doing here. They are reading songs.
Okay.
So some people do, you know, so listen to the lyrics.
The bigger words, is that the claim?
Well, as far as what lyric intelligence is, there's a more detailed story over at seatsmart.com. And if you want, we can dig in a little bit further into how they came up with these scores. But, you know, when you look at, I don't know if you've ever heard this, but USA Today is written at like a
fifth grade level.
7 or grade 5 or some really low level. So there are obviously ways to interpret by looking at words, you know, and sentences to determine what the reading level of that is.
Sure.
That is essentially what they've done here with lyrics instead of, you know, news articles or something like that.
Okay.
So back to the story here. Though declaring a winner in this insipid race to the bottom seems somewhat defeatist. Even further to that point, the most intellectually stimulating song, which was Blake Shelton's country hit All About Tonight, measured just 5.8. While Wading Deeply into the Ludicrous was 3 Days Grace's The Good Life at a level equivalent to 0.8. Begging the question, did they have to try to craft lyrics a kindergartner could easily read? So how did this happen and why is it getting even worse, asks theantimedia.org. For the sake of brevity, this is a systemic issue being reinforced across the board by pandemic anti-intellectualism.
Pandemic anti-intellectualism.
That's an interesting choice of words there.
So this is something I've been talking about for a very long time.
What, dumbing down?
Well, I don't think... See, I don't think that it's necessarily the plan, anyone's devious plan to dumb things down. I think that's a result. I think that when kids go to public school, the one thing that all kids seem to really, really get a hold of, or not all kids, but the vast majority of kids really seem to get, is that school sucks.
Yeah, for
sure. Like, it really, really sucks. And they don't want to go there. They don't want to learn. They don't want to be there. If even if they want to be there with their friends, they're essentially in day prisons, and everybody who's in authority, they suck too. And these attitudes around learning are really damaging. This is bad, bad news if you have these feelings. I remember these feelings.
Yeah, yeah. I've been
there. It's very, very easy to be cynical in junior high and high school. I mean, that's a time of your life when being cynical at this, I don't know whether it's always been that way historically. The people that I'm around who are of those ages tend to believe that somehow cynicism equates to worldliness or something like that. And that's bad, bad news, because cynicism doesn't help you much at all. It may keep you from making some mistakes. It's like, oh, that sucks. I won't do it. Okay. But you're not even talking about intelligent cynicism here. You can't even, in many cases, point to failures in the past so that you can look out for failures in the future. Many times it's just, like they say, systemic cynicism. What was their term?
Pandemic anti-intellectualism.
Yeah. And
so what you're saying is, Mark, that it's not some Illuminati plot to dumb people down and turn them into mindless drones.
No, it's the opposite. It's the people on the bottom that have come to the conclusion that the best result for them is dumb, is to be, you know, not educated.
So to take that a little bit further, what you're saying is that it's not a plot. It's just something that sort of happened over generations where, you know, one generation of people think school sucks. And so they just, you know, they're kind of not that smart. But then the next generation, the people who are not so smart because they didn't like school, the ones teaching the generation after that. And so that following generation is even dumber, and that it's more of a natural process than it is anything else?
No, I think it's an attitude, not really an issue of intelligence as much as it's an issue of an attitude towards learning.
But what you're saying is that the attitude towards learning is degrading over generations?
Yes.
Okay. So you're saying it's a natural process. But at the same time, we did talk to, who's the guy that wrote the book? John, I'm spacing on his name right now, the education guy from New York. Teacher of the Year.
Yeah, John Taylor Gatto.
John Taylor Gatto, yeah. He wrote several books about the sort of educational system in the United States, and he's talked about how there's this Prussian system, that this system is designed originally back in, I don't know, the 1800s or something like that, a long time ago, designed to create an underclass of not really too bright kind of not critically thinking folks who are going to plug into the system. They're going to get a job. They're going to work that job. They're not going to question things. They're not, certainly not going to question authority. They're certainly not going to refuse to obey authority. And that this was designed, that this was something that was very specifically, you know, created in a way to create this worker drone, essentially. I mean, don't you acknowledge that that could be the case?
I don't think so, because worker drones, you want to be compliant. You want them to be reasonably happy.
Mm-hmm.
But in fact, what they've done is they've created people that are unemployable. I mean, they're not worker drones. They're morons. They're a-holes. They're both dumb and angry. And this is the worst combination that you can come up with. Dumb and happy, whoa, not so bad. Angry and intelligent, that person can change the world. But a dumb and angry person's really only good for incarceration.
Are they angry? I mean, are you saying the average person who graduates from a government school is an angry person? What's your evidence?
Don't want to learn, you're angry. Pop music.
I don't know about
it's
that.
It's full of angry talk.
I don't know about that. How do you feel? The toll-free number here tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Seems to me there's plenty of distractions to keep them very, very, you know, entertained out there rather than
They're
angry.
They're not producing anything.
There's
That's not a worker
more
drone.
Coming up here in moments. Most of them have jobs. It's Free Talk Live.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
The IRS is a private corporation, not a government agency. Income tax is collected by voluntary compliance. To learn to unvolunteer or discontinue volunteering into the IRS, visit escapeharassment.com and immediately implement Strategy 1. The process must be repeated each and every time. Paper, letter, envelope, presentment, etc. Always and forever. Failure equates to acceptance, subsequent resultant contract, and you pay or go to jail by your own consent and agreement contract. Avoid recontracting. Visit escapeharassment.com and implement Strategy 1 immediately. Bar lawyers and accountants won't help you. Why wait? Get Strategy 1 and immediately implement it to divorce the IRS today and forever. That's escapeharassment.com, Strategy 1, to be free from the IRS. Escapeharassment.com.
The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love,
and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way.
Love as your guide.
And liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Back with more Free Talk Live, talking about dumbing down. Is it something that is created? Is it something that other humans are sort of molding and sculpting with the intention, purposefully, of making people dumber? Or is it just something that's happening over time because of the terrible institutions that we have, like the government schools, which is kind of what you were suggesting earlier, Mark, that, you know, these schools are so bad, they're not challenging students, they're just generally uninteresting and boring and awful.
Well, I don't know about challenging students. I'm not going to go and say that. I'm boring and awful. I'll go with you, but that's not, those aren't specific adjectives. What I would say is that public schools, my experience with public schools in the United States, and what I've seen, doesn't, you know, at no point have I seen any anything really to oppose this viewpoint, is that they have this institutional conversation amongst the students that this place sucks. And yep. And frankly, the teachers don't seem to be, they don't seem to have much of a different attitude. So if you've got everybody feeling that way inside your institution, there's not much you can do with it at that point. Something big and dramatic has to change. And I think institutional conversations are important. I think they're very real. I'm talking from the smallest one to the largest one. And when you are you're an administrator, a person in charge, you've got to do something when the institutional conversation begins to turn to something negative.
I want to come back to this discussion. You can bring up anything you'd like, though, so we're going to go to your calls and thoughts, but more about the musical, lyrical content. What grade level are these lyrics at? Looks like they are lower now than ever before, according to a recent study that looked at over 200 pop top songs over the last decade. But let's go to Miles, and Miles is calling from California on via Skype. Hello, Miles.
Hi, Ian. How are you guys doing
good
today?
You're on the air.
I'd like to talk about, go back to the topic that you guys brought up a few days back about the addiction to porn and addiction to video games.
Yes, sir.
That that professor was basically creating a hysteria about. I think that from listening to that show, I feel like there was a lot of people that were just way off base. And Mark, you brought up some good points about changing gender roles. But I didn't really hear anybody talk any sense at all in that show about the two topics. So I'd like to give my opinion. I'm kind of an expert in this field.
Okay.
Okay.
We'll take your word for it.
Does that mean you're addicted to porn and video games?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You're currently addicted?
Lifelong, yes.
Wow. Okay. Now, I know you had points you wanted to make, but now I'm curious.
Go ahead.
So you had lifelong, so from teenage years through, how old are you now?
I'm middle age.
So 40?
A little bit younger, but younger. Close, yeah.
So mid-30s. Okay, so this has been going on for quite a long time. When you say addicted, now normally an addiction means somebody has a problem to where it's affecting their life, right?
Well, yeah, and that's where I think there was a major disconnect in that show, is you guys were kind of defining that word like you just did. Where I think the professor that was saying this is a huge problem, most male are addicted to porn and video games, he was using addiction in a different way.
I don't think he said most young males, but he definitely said it was a problem.
Okay, well, I've heard this type of hysteria, not from him, but from many others that basically say that, yes, most young men are, quote, addicted to porn, and they're using it in a different sense, as you guys.
Well,
they're
saying
that.
What do you say? Yeah, what is the definition that you were?
Well, I'm just using it in the way of that I have to, I use it constantly, and
you're compelled. You feel compelled to use it. You can't go a day. How many hours can you, I mean, how many times a day are you self-pleasuring?
at this point, it's probably one, but there have been times where it was three or four. But
I mean, I'm presuming that your use of porn is also in tandem with self-pleasuring. I guess there could be someone who would be addicted to porn without self-pleasure.
It always is. I've looked into the topic heavily, and it always is.
Okay. And video games, how many hours a day?
I don't know, maybe an hour a day. Like, I'm not, I've been a gamer, you know, my whole life also, and I'm not using the term addiction in the way you guys are using it. Mm-hmm. I can't go without either one.
You cannot, or you can go?
I cannot.
You cannot go. Okay. So that would be an addictive factor for sure.
Yeah. You could say that's addiction, but neither have ever hurt my life. Matter of fact, they've enhanced my life greatly. Yes. And why is that surprising? You think that, you know, a couple hundred years ago that people wouldn't die for this kind of entertainment? Mm-hmm. I mean,
I don't know about die, but they'd certainly have liked to have had it. Porn's been with us a long time, and gaming's been with us.
Well, no, internet porn is a whole different animal.
Oh yeah.
Internet porn is it's recent, and it's way, way different than the porn from any other time. Like, we can get it instantly. We can constantly get new stuff. It's amazing. It's something we should be celebrating, not shaming.
I don't know if it's necessarily. I don't feel like we were shaming anyone here on Free Talk Live. We were just talking about an issue.
But 99% of the callers that called in sounded like rednecks from that, you know, grew up in the 50s.
Well, rednecks
that are all
religious too. I suspect
they're all religious. Yep. Well, everyone that called in was religious, saying, "Well, you know,
Jesus was
damaging.
Mentioned many times when in the topic of porn." And
ridiculous.
I thought it's kind of interesting. Why do you think of porn and Jesus at the same time?
Well, the definition, according to dictionary.com, of addiction is the state of being enslaved to a habit or practice, or to something that is psychologically or physically habit-forming, as narcotics, to such an extent that its cessation causes severe trauma. So if you were to go without, what would happen to you?
My life would suck worse. That's okay. It. Like, here, let me give you a video game example. Right now I work a lot, and I also recently, because of work, relocated to a new city. Well, because of video games, for my leisure time, I get on Skype, do a group Skype call with a bunch of friends, and we hang out while playing video games together.
You hang out online?
Yes. Got it. And you, Ian, were basically saying, well, these multiplayer games, it's not really a social experience. Yeah, I mean, you may be talking to someone, but you're mainly staring at a screen. Dude, the way it's happening, I mean, it's becoming more and more social, and that's the main thing that you guys did not address in the show. As technology progresses, same with porn is becoming closer and closer to real sex, and video games are becoming, the multiplayer aspect is becoming more and more closer to like very realistic social interaction where it used
to
be.
That's an interesting question. Is at what point does a video game, at what point is a video game able to accurately ape the social interaction of being with a human being, right? So, right now you could argue that there are very close to photorealistic video game graphics, right? Like you can get into a video game and
it's as good as a movie in many ways.
The characters are very convincing. The way they move is, you know, like they've done enough motion capture to be able to make somebody in a game look like they would be a human being, the way they walk, their gait, if you will, things like that. The facial expressions are certainly better now than they've ever been. You know, there's no doubt about that. But there's certain things, subtleties that are still lost, right? Like, so if you're in a video game, the character
is probably not going to have control over their eyeballs as far as where are they looking, right? Like if I'm in, right. You know, one of the reasons why I like to have people in my studio to do Free Talk Live as opposed to remote hosts is because I can make eye contact with Mark right now and
make sure that, you know, we're interacting in the conversation the way that we hope and the timing's better.
And you don't get that with an online game, but
not
I think
now.
You're bringing
not
up
now.
An interesting, not now. Now, but it could happen, right? With like Oculus Rift
could.
Or the...
No, it definitely will. It definitely will. No question about it. If anyone has seen, you know, studied the trends in gaming, it's an complete inevitability.
I agree with you, but that brings up the question of at what point, like what factors from real life would have to be copied in a video game to make it a true social interaction. And I'm not saying I'm not saying there aren't social aspects to these games, right? I mean, there's chat. I mean, back in the old days with role-playing games and things like that online, you could chat with people, and then they added voice, which is a way to interact with people.
What he's saying is that this doesn't really have to do with technology increases. You know, I could play with one of my good friends down in Florida. I could play Monopoly online. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we could chat back and forth, or we could get on the telephone and talk. I mean, many of these games have a component where people, you know, have audio. Mumble, I think, is what they use.
TeamSpeak's pretty popular.
TeamSpeak, okay.
But is that enough? Is that a true social interaction?
It's pretty
experience?
Close.
Yeah.
It's close. It's
close.
Getting. I mean, when I started gaming, we didn't have this, you know. And when I started, multiplayer was another guy sitting on a couch with you. Mm-hmm. That's what multiplayer consists of. Now multiplayer is I have friends in Canada, Europe, Russia, South America, Central America, the United States, East and West, North, South. Where we can all be on at the same time playing together, talking with each other. And there is absolutely nothing bad about that. And it's not getting worse, it's getting better. And let me say one last thing before you let me go.
You can hang on here. We'll bring it back in a moment. I don't know if I was saying it was bad necessarily, but if it is hurting your life, then I would say it is.
Well, I did it. I finally left the empire behind. And now that I'm safely settled in Chile, I'm gathering with others like me to build a new community called Fort Galt. Fort Galt is designed to be the ideal home base for professionals and their families to live and work in peace. If you're ready to ditch the superstate and bring your business to freer lands, visit us online at fortgalt.com. That's fortgalt.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
CopBlock has quickly become the top police accountability group in the United States, and maybe even the world. With chapters across the globe, there's probably a group near you that you can join. If not, you can start your own. Besides joining a local CopBlock group, you can also give just $1 a month to the CopBlock network. Your contribution helps support the efforts of those who make CopBlock possible. So please, join the CopBlock network now at copblock.lrn.fm. That's copblock.lrn.fm.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, May 24th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.13 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,206 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $240. Antiwar.com reports earlier this week, the Justice Department said that if there is no extension of Section 215 of the USA Patriot Act in place, they'd start winding down the NSA surveillance program this weekend. Bluff or not, they better start doing so because there will be no extension. The Senate went into recess Saturday afternoon after a pair of procedural votes aimed at extending the program both fell short of the 60 votes needed. With the Senate and House in recess, there's almost no chance of renewal of Section 215 before June 1st, when it formally expires. The first vote, aimed at an unamended version of the USA Freedom Act, which the House had already passed, fell short by just 3 votes, with 57 voting for and 42 against. The act was a watered-down reform bill that had been so watered down, many argued it actually enhanced government surveillance authority. The second vote, a 2-month extension of Section 215, aimed at just buying some time to get around threats of filibusters, also failed by a vote of 54-45. The House had not voted on this before recess, and Representative Justin Amash from Michigan claimed assurances that they would not attempt to rush through a recess voice vote over the weekend, even if the Senate passed it. The NSA telephone surveillance program allowed them to collect metadata about Americans' phone calls, though earlier this month, an appeals court ruled that Section 215 of the USA Patriot Act did not actually allow them to do this. In spite of ruling the program illegal, the court did not order that it be halted, and everyone was still presenting a 215 renewal as de facto approval for its continuation. Without even that renewal, it is hard to envision the administration justifying its continuation at all. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Ireland's government minister said voters overwhelmingly approved a measure to allow civil same-sex marriage, making it the first nation in the world to legalize gay unions through a popular vote. Campaigners on both sides of the debate said a victory was imminent. Those who opposed the amendment to the country's constitution to allow same-sex marriage conceded defeat in the heavily Roman Catholic country. David Quinn, the director of the conservative Iona Institute that was leading the charge against the referendum, tweeted a congratulatory message. He later said, despite the victory, we will continue to affirm the importance of the biological ties and of motherhood and fatherhood. He said, we believe we fought a good campaign. It was always going to be an uphill battle. However, we helped provide a voice to the hundreds of thousands of Irish people who did vote no. The fact that no political party supported them must be a concern from a democratic point of view. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a Cleveland police officer was found not guilty on Saturday in the shooting deaths of an unarmed man and woman after a high-speed car chase in 2012, one in a series of cases that have raised questions about police conduct and race relations in the United States. Judge John O'Donnell said Officer Michael Brillo acted responsibly in shooting the two suspects while standing on the hood of their surrounded car and firing multiple rounds through the windshield. Brillo, who was among a group of officers who fired on the car, was found not guilty of voluntary manslaughter and aggravated assault. O'Donnell said during the roughly half-hour-long reading of the verdict, Brillo was acting in conditions difficult for even experienced officers to imagine. A small crowd of demonstrators took to the streets to protest the verdict, chanting, "No justice, no peace." This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Millions of Americans are irrationally feared dead following a train derailment near Wilmington, Delaware.
Less than 200 people were aboard the train, but because no names have been released yet, countless more are being imagined trapped inside the wreckage by worried parents and overly anxious friends.
And the list of imagined victims is growing by the minute, from brothers-in-law who live in Delaware, who usually drive but could possibly have been on that train, to friends who went to Delaware on a business trip and may have been next to the tracks for some reason when the train derailed.
And sadly, we're getting reports that even those who have never been to Delaware are now also among those irrationally thought killed.
Oh, and we are just now getting word from Homeland Security that they're now warning people their fears may spiral into a wholly new fear that their loved ones never existed at all and are just byproducts of a drug-induced lucid dream in which their consciousness is currently imprisoned.
Such a shame, since this is reality.
There is nothing beyond this to believe otherwise. It would be folly.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can share with us your thoughts on whatever's on your mind here. It doesn't have to be what we've been discussing, which has been everything from Liberland, the new possible settlement that could be coming soon to Liberland. Also, dumbing down of lyrics. There's a study that's been done over the last decade of pop music, as well as country and, R&B, rap, and rock. They studied different genres, and they determined that there was a definite dumbing down over time, going from like already fairly dumb of third to fourth grade level reading of the lyrics to second to third grade level.
And the unlikely result that country came out as the smartest genre.
Yeah, that was kind of a shocker to me. We can continue with that discussion here. We also had Miles call in at the end of the last hour. He wanted to bring up a topic we had discussed previously on the show, which was about video game and porn addiction. He says he's an addict, but it doesn't harm his life, that he has it under control, that he in fact says it is enhancing his life, his addiction to video games and pornography. You don't go a day without either, Miles, and but you say that you still hold a job, you're productive, you're getting the bills paid, so...
As do 99% of people in my same scenario, yes, which is what you guys got
wrong. But does that mean they're addicted? I mean, if there's not some sort of problem with the withdrawal, right? Like withdrawal.
They're addicted in the way that guy that is trying to create this hysteria is using the word, which means using every day. He's saying that's a big
habit, isn't it? I mean, isn't that a habit versus an addiction? I mean, I do certain things every day, but if I were to stop doing those things, would there be a detriment to me? I think
call it habit or addiction, the point still stands that the guy is trying to say that there's a big problem when there really is none. And what I want to make clear is that every time you hear someone saying that a new something comes out about video games or killing the youth or porn addiction is a big problem, what's the common thread between all the people saying it is that they're all like, in their 50s or 60s and have
Zimbardo
absolutely
is pretty old.
No
I think
idea.
He's in his late 60s.
They just don't understand.
They do not understand at all. Mm. And it's the same old rock and roll is killing the youth argument. They do not understand.
Okay, so for me, like, I don't play video games every day, but when I do play a video game, I will binge on it for a series of hours, and I know that's hurting me, right? Like, it's hurting my productivity. I'm having fun, and it's okay to have fun.
Wait, is it hurting you? Wait, it's really hurting you? Like,
it's hurting my productivity. I'm not getting things done that I otherwise could get done.
Things done?
Yeah.
Like, you're saying, wait.
Accomplishing goals, things that I need to accomplish to live my life as successfully as possible, have a successful business and, grow that and, playing video
games. And activism. Make sure that you mention that. That's your number one purpose in life. I mean, that's, when it comes to activism, you're going to get that done.
Yeah.
The secondary thing is work. And then if you do a video game, what happens is that work suffers, but the activism tends not to.
I am not saying, my activism could suffer too. Like, I might play.
Does that happen?
I might, decide not to go and do something because I've been up too late playing video games.
Okay.
Now, rare that that happens, and, I accept that that's one of the costs of enjoying this particular hobby, and it's okay, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy, so I don't mind taking some time off, But there's no doubt that if I were to play video games like that more often, it would definitely be a deleterious effect to me. And you would admit that there are people who have a problem. And to me, I would define an addiction as a habit that has become a problem, meaning that you are suffering in some way from a possible loss of a girlfriend, loss of a job.
see, that's, you just made the same fallacy just now again, is that you're saying you might lose your girlfriend. Well, that's begging the question, man. That's begging the question.
Which question?
Who's to say that a girlfriend is better than porn? You're saying, oh, you might lose a girlfriend. That's a big deal. No, you have
brother,
to
you can have whatever life you want. I mean, that's cool.
I'm saying that you're saying that video games are getting in the way of me doing this, this, and this.
Yeah,
well, okay, you're begging the question that is better than video games.
Yeah, you're right. I am saying that human interaction is preferable to, women on screen. I'm going to say that.
Yeah, I'm going to have to go with Ian on this one, too, my life experience says that most people are going to be better off with a mate, and most people are going to be better off with a good-paying job.
No, those are awesome, yeah, but what that supposes is that those things will continue, that there's a dichotomy between the two, and that that video games are one thing, and that's something else, and that no matter what, that is automatically better. Where what I am pretty sure of is that as Mark suggested in that podcast radio show, that is that gender roles are changing, and that you can't look at porn because then you might not have a girlfriend. Well, I think things are going to change.
That's not what I said. I said that it becomes a problem where let's presume that you do value human interaction. All right, I'm not saying you do, but
why I play video games.
Okay, we were talking about pornography as well, though, right? So, let's say you value human interaction, you value having a partner, somebody who's in your life, who cares about you. You know, the porn girl, for instance, isn't going to cook for you. She's not going to snuggle with you in bed. They don't have a porn robot yet to where it's nice and warm and you can enjoy snuggling at night, that kind of thing. So there's definitely some things that the girls in porn aren't going to do for you. But let's say that you value having a partner like that. And then you have a porn addiction or a video game addiction or both that has progressed to the point where that partner, who otherwise was very, very nice and loved you very much, has now decided to leave you. I mean, that's a problem, right?
If you value that
right.
more.
If you do.
Yes.
If you value human interaction more than
now,
porn.
Now imagine this. Now imagine a scenario where not only are you sitting in front of a screen, taking care of business while watching a video. What if you're doing that and talking to the person and actually can feel the person and smell the person? And
we're talking about
Oculus
remote.
Rift. Think about an Oculus Rift situation. Uh-huh. There's Oculus Rift.
This is a virtual reality.
Is becoming a real thing. Like a real industry is popping up out of Oculus Rift.
I think it's great, man. I mean, I just want to make sure I'm clear with this. If that's what your priorities are, then by all means, dig in and have all the porn and the video games that you want to. Well, you're right. This is based on what people think is important. And if we both have different ideas as to what is important, then obviously we're not going to get on the same page with this one, right?
No, it's just my issue is that you're using an argument that is basically the same as what the religious people are using. You can't watch porn because Jesus.
I didn't say you can't watch porn.
No, not you, but I'm saying
you just said I was using a similar argument. So I'm not saying you can't watch porn. I'm just saying that to me, there is a point at which it becomes a problem. And you're saying, no, there's not that point.
Well, if it only becomes a problem if it's basically damaging, if it's changing your ability to get what you want in life. Most people want happiness.
That's
most
true.
People just want happiness. You're saying that activism for you is more important than happiness.
That's not true. Activism is happiness.
Messing with government bureaucrats is his greatest joy.
Yeah.
For you, yes, which is awesome. So then don't play video games.
That's happiness too. I'm happy all the time, so I can do whatever I want. But I'm not saying don't play video games or don't do activism or don't watch porn or don't have a relationship. I'm just saying that at some point it's going to become a problem. I don't hear that from you. And maybe I'm missing what you're saying here, but it sounds to me like you're saying that if porn and video games are some of the highest order for you, that's what your goal in life is, then there is no amount that is too much. Is that right?
I'm saying that if happiness is your goal in life, video games and porn are getting very, very good. They're changing. And I'm not seeing
But anyone... you are saying you can't have a problem, right? Like, if you love porn and video games, then more is better from your perspective, correct?
I mean, obviously...
Hey, embrace it, man. If that's what your thing is,
if,
then
no, well, if, that's your if thing. You're going to... Like, you know, there are people that take it too far where it impedes their happiness. I won't say that doesn't exist. It does. But porn and video games are getting better. Mm-hmm. I mean, okay. Constantly getting that's better. Fine. And they're getting to a point where...
Dude, embrace it if that's what you love to do. I'm not trying to convince you to stop watching porn or playing video games. I never was.
No,
thanks for the call tonight, Miles. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Just saying, maybe there's a point that it's going too far. Do you think that's possible, Mark? Are you with me
yes,
on this?
Yes, absolutely.
You're being kind of quiet
sure,
over
no,
there.
No,
okay.
I mean, it seemed obvious.
We'll come
me.
Back with more here in moments. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Warning, if you've recently declared bankruptcy, you're going to want to change the station because there's an alternative to bankruptcy and it's faster than you'd ever think possible. But if you've already declared bankruptcy and have missed this opportunity, you'll want to change the station now. Here it is. Right now, the company that has resolved more credit card debt than anyone in the U.S. is available to settle your debt, too. You may reduce your debt with one low monthly program payment. If you call right now, Freedom Debt Relief will show you how low your monthly program payment could be for free. Call now. 1-800-399-1993. That's 1-800-399-1993. If you're struggling with debt, this could be your answer. And the bigger your debt, the more money you could save. To find out for free how much of your hard-earned money Freedom Debt Relief could help you save, call now. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE if you can pull yourself away from your porn habit for just a moment. 855-450-3733. Yeah, I hope it didn't feel like I was like coming down on somebody. Look, hey, whatever your habits are, your habits, whatever your addictions are, or your addictions, whatever your vices are, you know, it's your business. Sorry, that was Skype. We'll bring our Skype caller here in just a moment. But, you know, it's your business. I don't care what you do with your time, but maybe you should be aware if you've got a problem or not. Is it possible that you could have a problem? Yeah, it's possible. What does it mean to have a problem? At what point of consumption of these things does it become a problem? I guess that's different for everybody.
That's for you to look at in your life. You have to be very clear as to what you want and how your life's going.
Speaking of vices, tell me about how to get some great deals on wine, Mark.
Well, you go to chwine.com. It'll, at the very least, if wine is a vice for you, you'll spend less money on it.
No doubt. And it's really good wine, too.
Yeah, what they do, what Cameron Hughes does is he travels around the world, and a great deal of that time is spent in Napa Valley. He gets some of the best wines in the world, and he buys their overages. This is the exact same wine. It's just the wine they weren't able to sell in bottles at $100 a piece. He takes them at his website, slaps his own label on them, and sells them from $10 to $30. These are high-end wines. They're delicious, and you're going to know the difference when you try them at chwine.com. Two of his cabs recently were rated over 90 points by Wine Spectator. So you have third parties saying that these wines are high-end wines. We recently tried a couple of them at the CAC at a wine tasting. They're fantastic. They were awesome. You can go to chwine.com, enter coupon code FTL by clicking on the microphone in the upper left-hand corner, and you'll get 20% off of select wines and free shipping. That's a pretty big deal. So there you go, 20% off and free shipping at chwine.com. You click on the microphone in the upper left and enter FTL.
All right, still to come, more discussion about lyrical content, the reading level that one would need to have to read some of the most popular song lyrics has been dropping over the years. But your calls come first. So let's go to John. He's in Chicago. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark. Hey, John.
Hi, Ian. Hi, Mark. I wanted to discuss Chris Cantwell.
Chris Cantwell is our co-host from Wednesday Nights who has been indefinitely suspended over something he said on Twitter.
Yeah, the N-word. Mm-hmm. And is there any possibility that you would reconsider him coming back? I mean, is there any way you can, you know, if he apologized?
Probably. Yeah, we already, I don't know, you must have missed the conversations we had about this topic earlier in the week. I think it was Wednesday night when we really dug into this deep. But yeah, I mean, there's a path back for Chris, and I would hope that we can have him back on the air at some point.
Okay.
Is that all you wanted to know?
What will he need to do, basically?
He's going to need to apologize for using...
Okay. You already say he wouldn't apologize, so that's out.
Well, I mean... So, I've talked to him about it. We'll see what happens in the future. But, you know, for now, that's the apology has to be on the table. Otherwise, we're the show that has the guy who's the unapologetic N-word user. And
Mark. He did apologize for the frustration and the difficulty that he may have caused Free Talk Live. And further, he did say that he would think twice in the future about doing that again. I felt like that was good enough, personally. But you're saying that's not enough for you?
I think there needs to be an apology for using that word.
No. It's enough for me. I just...
No, I was asking Mark.
I'm hearing him on Wednesday night on Free Talk Live, and I'm just wondering if there's any path for his getting back on. Yeah,
there you go, John. Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So what I was asking, I wasn't asking John, I was asking you, Mark, what whether that was acceptable enough. And you're saying no?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's no, it's not. It's it's kind of like saying, I'm sorry you're ugly. You know, it's just like, it's not, it's an apology around the subject. I mean, there has to be an apology for the subject. The reason he was suspended was for using the word, not because he put us in jeopardy.
But you used the same word that very night on the air on Free Talk Live when you were quoting him.
Yeah, I quoted what he said. It's not the utterance of the word, it's how it's employed, right? Like, he used the N-word and said to a black man who was asking him some questions on Twitter, right? Like, he's a comedian with a popular podcast that opens himself up on Twitter for conversation. The guy, you know, is trying to have a conversation. Admittedly, he's badgering Chris. There's no doubt about it. And Chris says, shut up, N-word. That's not what I did. All I did was quote him. Do you understand that there's a complete and utter difference?
I understand what you're saying.
There's a difference between me saying that you're, you know, a flaming butthole and saying that, you know, somebody recently called you a flaming butthole.
Okay, so would you want to make him apologize for calling someone a spick, for instance?
Right. Well, I think that is an inappropriate term to use, right? But I think also that it isn't the nuclear option that the N-word is.
Yeah.
And so what I've seen is all I'm doing is looking inside my industry and seeing what happens to people that employ the N-word. And what happens to people who employ the N-word is they get fired. And I don't want Free Talk Live to be fired off of its 158 radio stations any more than you do. And those radio stations, if an organization like Media Matters or whatever gets a hold of this, and it's not unlikely that they will, Free Talk Live is growing into quite a show, and we have to be prepared for these things. We have to, if you want to be the big show, you need to act like the big show. And to act like the big show, if you have a co-host who drops the N-bomb, that co-host needs some kind of reprimand. Now on Free Talk,
well, he's been indefinitely suspended.
Agreed.
So that's a reprimand. But so what you're saying is you don't want him to apologize to the person. You just want him to apologize for using that word.
Right. Essentially, here in America, look, I don't make the rules. All I do is observe how things look. Here in America, the use of the N-word is an insult to everybody who claims to be a black person, right? Or the vast majority of them. We did have a black lady call in that evening and say that, you know, use it all you want. I don't care. It doesn't mean anything to me.
Yeah.
And I'm certain there are other people with that opinion. But those aren't the ones with the podium. They're not the ones with the microphone. The people with the microphone and the podium are going to get you taken off the air. Do you think that the people with the microphones and the podium agree with Free Talk Live's stand on liberty?
Probably not.
Yeah, they don't. And that means that they will use this lever, this ability to go after Free Talk Live and any talk radio show. They're not just going to stop at Free Talk Live. They're going to say, at all of conservative talk radio, as though we're conservative. And they're going to lump us all together and try to throw us all in, you know, under the bus. And that's all I'm saying is that you don't give people like that an opportunity.
Yeah, I guess I feel like you've put Chris in a position that's going to be difficult for him to come back from because on one hand, you're not demanding he apologize to this person who was badgering him on Twitter. I mean, his purpose was to insult this person, and that's what, you know, that was what his goal was. I don't believe Chris is a racist.
He wanted to
say something that would be as incisive and as a low blow and as an insult as possible. So he's not going to want to apologize for that, and you're not asking him for that. You're asking him to apologize for using that word, which it seems like, you know, on one hand, he's not going to apologize to that person. On the other hand, he has already apologized for whatever danger that he may have put us in and further has said he would think twice about doing so in the future. So that seems to me like an acceptable thing. But anyway, we'll come back with more here. 855-450-FREE. You can share how you think on whatever you want on Free Talk Live.
Hi, John Huebner from Midas Resources. Are you tired of watching your hard-earned assets dwindle away? As government spending is out of hand and the Federal Reserve is creating in excess of $20 billion a week, are you tired of stockbrokers gambling away your hard-earned money? Is this market a setup for a crash greater than 1987? Too many of today's policies resemble those that led to the collapse of 1929. This is John Huebner, and that was me in 2007.
And we all know what happened when the subprime credit bubble burst. By March 2009, the dollar lost 50% of its value. The entire U.S. banking system was on the verge of collapsing. Like all financial problems of the past, is history about to repeat itself? Call me, John Huebner, at 1-800-686-2237, extension 129, before it's too late to protect yourself. Will the oncoming catastrophe take all private IRAs, 401ks with it? There is a way to protect your hard-earned assets. Call me, John Huebner, at 1-800-686-2237. 6-2-2-3-7, extension 129.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Are you a sneezer? If you're not, can you get close to one? I don't literally mean someone sneezing. Sneezer, as defined by marketing guru Seth Godin, is an opinion leader. When a sneezer mentions something, other people catch what Godin calls the idea virus. Seth Godin says some people are more likely to tell their friends about a great new idea. So identifying and courting sneezers is a key success factor for idea merchants. His book, Unleashing the Idea Virus, is the most downloaded ebook in history, and you can download the whole book free. That's how he's making his idea contagious. Click tips, tricks, and other stuff to help you cut through the clutter at www.survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. It is the live Sunday edition of the program. We do have time for you here if you want to share your thoughts with us about whatever's on your mind, anything from what we've already discussed to whatever happens to be on your mind. We were talking about the lyrical intelligence of song lyrics, popular music lyrics, and how it's been getting worse over time, that the grade level, the reading level of the lyrics has been slowly falling over the last decade and probably beyond that, but the study only covered the last 10 years. Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE, but we continue with your calls and thoughts in a moment. I want to also let you know how to get Bitcoin. It is ExpressCoin.com, the best choice for getting your cryptocurrency, whether it's Bitcoin, Litecoin, or even Dogecoin. You go to ExpressCoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, and you can feel good because they are a licensed money services business, and you can get your cryptocurrency with money order or check
It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive, and you can even do it from your smartphone with their app, which you can download at expresscoin.com. Use coupon code FTL, and you'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no transfer fee at all. So get started over at expresscoin.com, and don't forget coupon code FTL at expresscoin.com. As we continue with your calls, we've got Zach in Ithaca on the line via Skype. Hello, Zach.
Hey, how are you doing? Can
Good,
you hear me?
Sir. Go ahead. Yep, you're great. Go ahead.
I spend a lot, perhaps an excessive amount of time on Twitter. It might be my own personal masturbatory addiction, if you want to call it that. But one of the trending topics today was Chuck C. Johnson, the self-described Twitter terrorist, internet troll slash pseudo-journalist guy.
Twitter he terrorist.
He described himself as that.
What does that mean?
He said, you may be social justice warriors, but I am a Twitter terrorist. And that was one of the tweets of his I retweeted because he's playing a character. He's made that clear. I first heard of him. The point is that he's a trending topic today because his account has been suspended for the fourth time.
Uh-huh.
We can go into that if you want. But I first heard of him about a month ago on the Joe Rogan Experience podcast number 640, where Joe Rogan had him on simply because he kind of wanted to understand what was going on with this guy and what he was up to. And he originally came to prominence because they had that supposed gang rape that went on at the fraternity that was covered in Rolling Stone, and then the story fell apart.
Yeah, that story did fall apart.
He was the guy that basically was the one who unraveled the sweater by pulling on the string. Like, he called the fraternity, he so on and so forth. And then he, in turn, got branded as outing a rape accuser, whereas his point was there never was a rape to have been accused, and really he was exposing a liar. So, and it goes on from there. He's done intentionally outrageous, continuous trollish things online simply because that's, you know, what his whole thing is. Do you understand what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I am unfamiliar with this character, but I've heard some of the stories you're talking about. You're saying he's playing a character, that Chuck Johnson is not actually, like, you know, sort of like Chris Cantwell plays a character, that the real Chuck Johnson isn't what he's like on Twitter, or what?
Well, the way it was described on Joe Rogan is that his real name is Charles C. Johnson, but that was taken by some guy in Michigan, so he became Chuck.
Mm-hmm.
And he does, on some level, he makes money doing what he's doing. He has a staff, and he was a right-wing kind of commentator guy. He has a lot of legit credentials on his resume. He's parlayed that into becoming whatever. He's a new specimen, but I don't really have an opinion one way or another. Except that the guy likes it when people, you know, say what he wants them to say, and then other times he bashes people who he is opposed to. But
why did Twitter suspend him? What's their official reason for the suspension? Because, I mean, you know,
I've never heard of a Twitter suspension.
Yeah, being controversial.
It happens.
I mean, just being controversial shouldn't get you suspended.
The specific tweet for this suspension was, there is another person on Twitter named, he's at DeRay. A guy who's an online activist, and he and Chuck C. Johnson have had a war of words over the long periods of time. And Chuck C. Johnson put up a tweet that said, if I have enough money, I can track down anybody. And then a following tweet saying, anyone who helps you want to raise money to destroy at DeRay, go to this GoFundMe right here. And that was last night. And I woke up this morning and they're talking about, I woke up this afternoon, and they're talking about how his account's suspended, people are dancing on his grave, other people are comparing this to censorship, like even the biggest troll in the world should be allowed to have a voice.
Idea that he was, you know, the suggestion was that was violence, that he was going to take him out in some sort of a violent
destroy
manner?
Destroy doesn't sound like the right term.
It says here, go to gotnews.com/donate if you want to give money to taking out at DeRay.
And then at DeRay took umbrage to this. He reported it saying, I feel threatened.
Mm-hmm.
Then he equated it to, if he said, I'm going to take out the cops, that he'd have them beating down his door.
He's probably right about that.
Mm-hmm.
I think he, you know, everyone is using this. The at DeRay guy is as much of a troll on some level as Chuck C. Johnson. They're out there beating their chests and doing it ultimately for their own benefit, you know, I think. Regardless, I find it very fascinating and kind of tying into your discussion about the N-word. Can I say it? Can I say the
N-word? I'd prefer you not do that. I'd have to dump you if you did.
I asked. You know, we all have safe words. But, you know, that is the nuclear option when it comes to, you know, saying something intended to make someone upset. It's it's the worst thing you can say. Chuck C. Johnson, he likes to play around on Twitter. He said, people like calling him a ginger because he's a redhead.
Yeah.
And he said, I don't have to tell you what ginger is an anagram for, you racist. Ha 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 ha. Like, so the guy's doing it for his own entertainment as much. And I predict that when this all blows over.
Oh, I just figured that one out. Okay.
Yeah,
oh,
exactly.
You are so quick.
He is going to have another Twitter account, or he's going to do something else. Oh, what this might be tied into is the leak of all the adult friend finder information. He's been going through it. He's already outed one guy with a security clearance. And Andrew Ondheimer, whatever, this other major internet troll guy, they're kind of like frenemies online. And he says when he gets back online, they're going to be leaking all the weird people who were on Adult Friend Fire. Not weird, but people in positions of influence. So maybe that's why his Twitter got nuked. It was because he's about to dox a bunch of people.
It sounds a little paranoid. I don't know, man. That's a good question. It says here he expects to have, this is Recode.net reporting on it, that Johnson says he was not threatening the man's life and expects to have his Twitter account back in the next day or two. However, Twitter is not commenting on the suspension, so it is not known officially for how long he is suspended.
This will all play right into Chuck C. Johnson's hands.
Oh, yeah.
It's not his obituary, and people like to think it is, but the guy's going to come back and keep being the same trollish troll that he likes to troll. And it's kind of fun to watch. I don't know.
Does this have any correlation to Cantwell, or did you just thought you'd mention it because it's has some similarities?
It seems like every topic you guys have is related to every other topic because this is life,
And
it's all interwoven. And I like hearing you guys talk about interesting things. That's why I encouraged Sean Atwood to call in for 7 months, and that turned out to be one of the most fascinating conversations I've ever heard in my life.
Call. Hey, thanks for the call tonight, Zach. Appreciate hearing
from you. Keep encouraging interesting people to call in.
Yeah, appreciate that.
Hashtag Twithaca all the way.
Thanks,
I love
dude.
You guys.
Appreciate that. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I do have an article here, Mark, by Gawker.com. What is Chuck Johnson and why? The web's worst journalist explained. If you were active on social media this weekend, this is kind of old here. This is from 2014, so he's been around for a little bit. You may have noticed frequent references to a website called Got News and a writer named Charles C. Johnson. Often these references took the form of tweets like, hey, Twitter, @support, can you ban @ChuckCJohnson forever and prevent him from using your website to harass more people? And then other tweets that are very similar asking Twitter to ban this guy. Who is @ChuckCJohnson and why do people want him banned from Twitter? This guide is for the lucky few who haven't caught up on the story of Chuck C. Johnson and are curious why so many people, particularly in the mainstream media, despise him. Who is he? Johnson is a California-based 26-year-old independent journalist and proprietor of GotNews.com, where he publishes the majority of his articles. According to his online biography, he's written for a litany of conservative publications in the past, including The Wall Street Journal, Weekly Standard, and New York Sun. He's also the author of two books, one of which is enthusiastically blurbed by Texas Senator Ted Cruz. He's a conservative journalist? Not exactly. Johnson rejects being labeled as a conservative. He describes himself instead as a radical and a revolutionary. He frequently feuds with other conservative journalists. In a tweet published earlier in December, Johnson wrote, quote, I'm going to enthusiastically burn down the entire political establishment for fun. It's time someone did. Doesn't sound so bad so far. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Plus, we'll talk about that friend finder hack. I've got that story, too.
Every summer we go to Canyon Woods. Love getting outside. Love the hiking. Hate the itching and irritation from poison ivy, bug bites, all the things that keep me inside. So I need something strong.
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing is clinically proven with the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief of itching and irritation with 7 moisturizers to help heal skin.
I finally have the relief I need.
Hey, Jan, check this out.
On my way.
Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Are you suffering from EP?
The symptoms include fraudulent charges to your credit card. Your subway card says it's empty, but you bought it yesterday. Someone's been in your hotel room, but the desk clerk says they only show you entering the room. These are signs of EP, electronic pickpocketing. Payment cards, transit cards, even hotel room keys use a radio chip, so you can just wave your card at the register, the turnstile, or your hotel room door. But what's convenient for you is also convenient for thieves, waving scanners to electronically pickpocket you without even touching you. The good news is there's a cure. ID Stronghold has created leather wallets and clutches that have built-in EP protection, layers of shielding material cleverly concealed in a beautiful leather wallet that stops the symptoms of EP. Go to IDStronghold.com now and get the cure. IDStronghold.com. Warning, ID Stronghold wallets could lead to feelings of safety and security, comfort in crowds, and euphoria. If you experience these emotions, immediately inform your friends and family about IDStronghold.com so they can feel better too.
Free Talk Live.
The reason why I reject violence, and part of that is there's a humility in it, and that you have to acknowledge that I may not be right. You know, I want to have an open discussion with people. Let's talk this stuff out. I'm not going to impose my views on you with violence, because I will not presume to be so right that I can, that I'm just going to force my views on you.
In addition, if your views are so valid and so great, then you shouldn't have to force them on anybody. Then you should be able to persuade folks.
Right. This is truly the acid test of a good idea. If it's a good idea to educate everybody, then you should be able to do it in a free market. If it's a good idea
without force.
If you've got enough persuasive ability to convince a majority of people to vote to violently fund something, you've got enough potential to motivate that many people to contribute toward it.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're welcome to join us on the radio waves here on this live Sunday edition. We got time for you. 855-450-FREE. We just had Zach in Ithaca telling us about this Chuck C. Johnson guy on Twitter. I hadn't heard about him before, but had you, Mark? Had you heard about him?
Never heard the term. No, never heard the name.
He's been banned from Twitter, and I don't know how often that happens, but there's an article here over at Gawker about, you know, who is this guy? Why should we care about him? And I don't know if yet I do care about him. I'm indifferent at this point, but I'm curious to know a little bit more about it. Apparently, he was banned for saying he was going to take out someone, another Twitterer. And, you know, what does it mean to say you're going to take someone out? That could mean that you're going to take them out in a nonviolent manner, that you're going to just take them out of the
Twitter sphere. I'm going to drive them off of Twitter in the way that, say, Joss Whedon has been, driven off of Twitter, or at least shut down his Twitter account because he couldn't handle the noise or whatever it was.
But as the person to whom he wanted to take out, that he tweeted this at, said, and rightfully so, he's a black guy, by the way, that was the one that was tweeted at, the one that was supposedly going to be taken out. As he pointed out, if he were to write the same thing, you know, at NYPD, you know, tweet at them that I'm going to take you out, that's going to get you a felony charge or something like that.
It's at the very least going to get you a visit.
Yeah, it's going to get you some kind of criminal threatening charge. I mean, we've seen, Mark, people who've been arrested and charged with things and ultimately maybe drop those charges later, but have gone through a hellacious time simply for posting things like song lyrics on Facebook.
Yeah, we have seen song lyrics.
So who is Charles C. Johnson? This is Gawker.com. He is a 26-year-old independent journalist and a proprietor of a news website. Going on here, they say he's not exactly a conservative journalist. He's rejected being labeled a conservative and has even said that he's going to enthusiastically burn down the entire political establishment for fun. It's time someone did. Another question from Gawker. So he's a crazy conservative journalist. Well, sort of. Johnson is well known for ending the career of a foreign policy analyst named Elizabeth Obagi, who, among other things, misrepresented her academic credentials to her employer, the Institute for the Study of War. More recently, he's drawn attention for his flawed reporting in the Senate Republican primary race in Mississippi. And
so it's, it's in the area of journalism, it's really, really, really important to be able to go after people in the government and show them when they tell lies. So, that gives this guy a lot of cred in my book. Now, they're claiming that his other reporting is flawed, but I don't know how or why.
If he's just another crazy conservative journalist, why has he become so internet famous is the next question. The answer: Johnson is equally well known for publishing stories that fall apart under the slightest scrutiny. The list of Johnson stories that have been proven wrong is long, but his greatest hits include... Now, remember, this was written in December, so, who knows what he's written since then.
There's another 6 months or almost 6 months.
Right, some of his greatest hits include falsely accusing a New York Times reporter of secretly posing for Playgirl. After that, the reporter... Uh-oh. David Kirkpatrick published a story that deflated a few Benghazi conspiracy theories.
I'll let you finish that sentence again. I'm sorry about that. Playgirl these days, not so much of an insult, right? Like, Playgirl isn't exactly catching somebody who's in the porn industry. It's much more it's much more art than many of these other things.
When's the last time you checked out a Playgirl?
It was Playgirl, Playboy.
I said Playgirl originally, and you said Playgirl when you were talking to me.
Oh, so I see. I'm sorry. I was thinking Playboy. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you're saying you haven't read Playgirl recently?
No, I know. I haven't read. Okay. I haven't checked out Playboy recently either.
Got it.
But I did, however, send a subscription of Playgirl to a guy in prison who had bothered me right after I got out.
So that way everyone would see him getting the magazine, kind of thing?
He would actually have to go to the front office and return it in some way. But, he would. It's going to get around.
Erroneously reporting that former is another one of his supposedly bad stories. Erroneously reporting that former Newark Mayor Cory Booker didn't actually reside in Newark, and further contributing reporting to the Daily Caller's infamous story about New Jersey Senator Bob Menendez allegedly soliciting prostitutes in the Dominican Republic. The story turned out to be complete fabrication and may have even been planted by the Cuban government. Plus, he thinks Obama is gay. And then they cite
a lot of people say that, but I just don't care, I guess.
He does say that, quote, "I know we aren't supposed to talk about this, but Obama is clearly gay, guys. Not that there's anything wrong with that," he says. And there's some other related tweets as well. But skipping ahead, Johnson seems pretty clearly incompetent, but why do people loathe him? Johnson's work for larger news organizations is mostly inept rubbish, but the stuff he publishes on gotnews.com tends to be intensely hateful, bizarre, non sequitur, victim-attacking bile, directly from and directly for the online right-wing's ID. Johnson likes to publish articles, for example, insinuating that victims of police violence, particularly black victims, pretty much had it coming. Earlier this year, he collected screenshots of murdered teenager Michael Brown's Instagram account, and wrote, quote, "Brown's Instagram account also shows a violent streak that may help to explain what led to a violent confrontation with police officer Darren Wilson," Johnson wrote. In other words, Brown deserved to die. He gave a similar treatment to pregnant woman named Donella Connors, who was blinded by a beanbag fired by police officers in Ferguson, Missouri, to quell protesters. Since Connors apparently lacked a criminal record, Johnson went after her boyfriend, DeAngelis Lee, in an article titled, quote, "Breaking: Blinded pregnant Ferguson protester's boyfriend tried killing cops with car is criminal," unquote. To drive the point home, Johnson embedded a video of Lee rapping. "That's really racist," says the questioner. Yes, and these articles also put a lie to Johnson's self-spun image as a radical patriot fighting against the political establishment. In article after article, he props up the interest.
This happens to me all the time. I mean, when people want to take down Free Talk Live a peg, the first thing they do is they say, hey, you know, one of their main hosts, Mark Edge, he's a convicted murderer. Mm-hmm. He's a convicted murderer, right. murderer. Like, they just say this over and over again. I kind of knew that going in, that when I came out as Mark Edge and got rid of my name, Manwich, that this was going to happen. Right, like, you know, it was going to happen. It was all part of the plan.
What's that have to do with this guy, Charles Johnson?
Well, I think that to some extent, when you are a protester, that the expectation should be, you know, this lady's out pregnant protesting. I'm not saying she deserved to get to lose an eye or get shot in the face or anything like that, but, you know, the news about your life is going to come out. It shows success, for one. It shows that you have had some level of success. I don't know specifically whether Michael Brown deserved it or not, but it's not racist to look up his criminal record.
It's not just – well, I agree with you. I don't really necessarily feel like what he said there was racist, but that's what the article says here.
Well, yes. The article is written by some flaming liberal who says if you say something bad about a black person, you're a bigot. And that is, in and of itself, racism.
Well, it does point out here, and probably correctly so, that despite his image of this radical patriot fighting against the political establishment, in article after article, he props up the interests of one of the most powerful political lobbies in the country – the police. It's not just Johnson's attitude toward people of color who've been victimized by cops. Johnson in general likes to retaliate against certain individuals by publishing their personal information, aka doxing. A recent example, after the New York Times published a copy of former Ferguson cop Darren Wilson's marriage certificate and named the street on which he used to live, Johnson published the home addresses down to the house and apartment numbers of the pair of reporters who authored the Times story. The headline read, "Why can't we publish addresses of New York Times reporters?" And I would say that's well within his First Amendment rights to do. That it's, you know, if it's public information, then you can publish that information. That's, you know, I don't think that's a problem, but it certainly is a tacky thing to do. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah, New York Times probably wouldn't post his address, which shows who the better news agency is.
Is that why people want Twitter to permanently ban him is the next question. Well, the most recent calls for Johnson to be banned from Twitter, and again, what brought this guy up to our radar is a caller earlier who said he was just banned from Twitter, finally, arose from Johnson's decision to publish what he claims is the full name of Jackie, the woman who spoke to Rolling Stone about being raped at UVA fraternity in 2012. It's not yet clear whether the name Johnson published is Jackie's real name, but Johnson was so sure that Jackie lied about being raped that he began issuing threats on Twitter to publish more information about her, saying, "I'm giving Jackie until later tonight to tell the truth, and then I'm going to start revealing everything about her past." But our caller said that he was right about this one, that this girl did lie about being raped?
Yes. The story was, yes, that's correct.
And I don't know if this author knew about that at the time when writing this piece, so I'm not sure what the time frame is there. So anyway, that's some information about who this guy is. Let's go to Tom.
If the author leaves the story up, it just shows credibility on that part of that author.
In
that
Hudson, you're on Free Talk Live. Tom.
Yeah, I get requests in the mail from various nonprofits asking me for money. And one of the ones I got recently, which I respectfully declined, was the hate-mongering bigots known as Mothers Against Drunk Driving, so-called. They're not all mothers, and they're not against drunk driving. What they are is a hate group that promotes bigotry and unprovoked state-sponsored violence against anybody younger than 21, no matter how responsibly the person drinks alcohol.
Tom, thanks for the call. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. We'll come back with more here in moments. Hour number three is on the way. This is Free Talk Live.
Warning, if you've recently declared bankruptcy, you're going to want to change the station, because there's an alternative to bankruptcy, and it's faster than you'd ever think possible. But if you've already declared bankruptcy and have missed this opportunity, you'll want to change the station now. Here it is. Right now, the company that has resolved more credit card debt than anyone in the U.S. is available to settle your debt, too. You may reduce your debt with one low monthly program payment. If you call right now, Freedom Debt Relief will show you how low your monthly program payment could be for free. Call now. 1-800-399-1993. That's 1-800-399-1993. If you're struggling with debt, this could be your answer. And the bigger your debt, the more money you could save. To find out for free how much of your hard-earned money Freedom Debt Relief could help you save, call now. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, May 24th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.13 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,206 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $240. Antiwar.com reports earlier this week, the Justice Department said that if there is no extension of Section 215 of the USA Patriot Act in place, they'd start winding down the NSA surveillance program this weekend. Bluff or not, they better start doing so because there will be no extension. The Senate went into recess Saturday afternoon after a pair of procedural votes aimed at extending the program both fell short of the 60 votes needed. With the Senate and House in recess, there's almost no chance of renewal of Section 215 before June 1st, when it formally expires. The first vote, aimed at an unamended version of the USA Freedom Act, which the House had already passed, fell short by just 3 votes, with 57 voting for and 42 against. The act was a watered-down reform bill that had been so watered down, many argued it actually enhanced government surveillance authority. The second vote, a 2-month extension of Section 215, aimed at just buying some time to get around threats of filibusters, also failed by a vote of 54 to 45. The House had not voted on this before recess, and Representative Justin Amash from Michigan claimed assurances that they would not attempt to rush through a recess voice vote over the weekend, even if the Senate passed it. The NSA telephone surveillance program allowed them to collect metadata about Americans' phone calls, though earlier this month, an appeals court ruled that Section 215 of the USA Patriot Act did not actually allow them to do this. In spite of ruling the program illegal, the court did not order that it be halted, and everyone was still presenting a 215 renewal as de facto approval for its continuation. Without even that renewal, it is hard to envision the administration justifying its continuation at all. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Ireland's government minister said voters overwhelmingly approved a measure to allow civil same-sex marriage, making it the first nation in the world to legalize gay unions through a popular vote. Campaigners on both sides of the debate said a victory was imminent. Those who opposed the amendment to the country's constitution to allow same-sex marriage conceded defeat in the heavily Roman Catholic country. David Quinn, the director of the conservative Iona Institute that was leading the charge against the referendum, tweeted a congratulatory message. He later said, despite the victory, we will continue to affirm the importance of the biological ties and of motherhood and fatherhood. He said, we believe we fought a good campaign. It was always going to be an uphill battle. However, we helped provide a voice to the hundreds of thousands of Irish people who did vote no. The fact that no political party supported them must be a concern from a democratic point of view.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a Cleveland police officer was found not guilty on Saturday in the shooting deaths of an unarmed man and woman after a high-speed car chase in 2012, one in a series of cases that have raised questions about police conduct and race relations in the United States. Judge John O'Donnell said Officer Michael Brillo acted responsibly in shooting the two suspects while standing on the hood of their surrounded car and firing multiple rounds through the windshield. Brillo, who was among a group of officers who fired on the car, was found not guilty of voluntary manslaughter and aggravated assault. O'Donnell said during the roughly half-hour-long reading of the verdict, Brillo was acting in conditions difficult for even experienced officers to imagine. A small crowd of demonstrators took to the streets to protest the verdict, chanting, "No justice, no peace." This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Jack Daniel's announced today its plan to start marketing directly to children, adding, quote, "Why not?" Executives for the whiskey company told reporters that they've already slated dozens of television spots showing 10-year-old children drinking tumblers of Jack and Coke in playgrounds, and that the company was planning on, quote, "just seeing how it all played out."
Every year, Jack Daniel's sells millions of dollars of great American whiskey to men and women all over the world. So for our next ad campaign, we basically just thought, hey, why not just start marketing this stuff straight to 10-year-olds? I mean, if they catch us, they catch us, but we'll see how far it goes, and hopefully we can sell some alcohol along the way. Sure, some parents' groups could get upset, especially if we go with our idea of moms serving their kids cranberry jack at snack time. But
in other news, a doomed rabbit will teach an 8-year-old a lesson about responsibility, and a torrent of soap issues from a wildly unexpected part of the dispenser. Well, that was it. It's all downhill from here, bud. For more, visit theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us here on the radio waves and bring up anything you'd like. 855-450-FREE is our number. That's toll free, 855-450-3733. Also, you may join us via Skype. At Skype username lrn.fm. With you in studio, Ian here.
And Mark.
In the last couple hours, at one point, we did start a story from the antimedia.org about the dumbing down of pop music's lyrics. The study, or there was a study done over at, let's see, this is Seat Smart. You go to, there's a link in the antimedia story to the full details of this study if you really want to dig in to how it was done. But they studied 225 Billboard songs, so the top music in four categories, pop, country, hip-hop, and rock genres. And they determined that over the last decade, the intelligence of the lyrics has gone down from
the grade level of it.
Right. So from like third or fourth grade level a decade ago to second to third grade level now. And this
it's
is
hard
on
to
average.
Slip down much farther than that, right?
Like, well, right.
Kindergarten level, I figure, is they can't read. Cat. You know, like there's nothing left.
Well, this is on average, right? So there are songs that have lower levels. So they give a list here on the Seat Smart site of, you know, where they're really breaking down the study of the top 10 dumbest songs over the last 10 years. And the number one dumbest is The Good Life by 3 Days Grace, a 2010 song with a word count of 215, 3.1 characters per word, and 1.1 syllables per word, giving it an average grade level of 0.8. So less than a first grade reading level, according to the study for that song. Going on here, though, from the antimedia.org, because we talked about sort of the dumbing down of the lyrics and also just in the educational system. And Mark, you had said that this seems more like a symptom than something that is pre-planned or being manipulated by, let's say, the elites or, you know, the Illuminati or something like
that.
Whatever
it is, yeah.
And I don't know, Mark. I mean, whether it's whoever's behind this, I don't know. But looking at the education system, you can see that the education system, John Taylor Gatto did the research into this, and he's talked about it quite a bit, that it was a Prussian system, and that system was designed to make an obedient class of people.
Obedient is one thing.
You don't want your obedient people to be smart.
Yeah, smart's not a problem. It's critical thinking skills, and those are really different.
Really? You don't think a smart person's more likely to critically think?
I think they're
think?
More likely, but okay. What is the value of a stupid person?
They can do stuff without question?
Not really. Nope. Stupid people, they really can't do things. They can't do anything well. If you find somebody who has an IQ below a 100 and you have the choice of whatever the job is, and you have the choice of a person with an IQ of 100 versus a person with an IQ of, say, 85, you want the person with the IQ of 100 because they can do the job better. Now, the fact is that IQ is not by any stretch of the imagination the whole of intelligence, but it's a picture. It's a snapshot. There are several different areas of intelligence, and people can be intelligent in one area and stupid in another.
Well, we've certainly seen, you're right though, Mark, that we've seen that very intelligent people can come up with ways to control others, for instance. So just because you're smart doesn't mean you're going to question the system that you've been raised to be intelligent within, I guess.
Yep.
So there is that. And let me go on here though. This is the analysis here from theantimedia.org. So I already told you the basics, that the lyrical content, the level of reading required is going down over the years to be able to read the lyrics of these songs. When just six corporations control 90% of the media and 80% of radio stations have identical playlists, mindless content isn't a choice, it's a virtual mandate. In this self-propelled cycle of banality, the conglomerates dictate content to be promoted by radio, which in turn pushes it endlessly, creating a false perception that what is being played is due to listener demand. But this insidious marketing ploy is more akin to kidnapping and is every bit as dangerous. There's a dearth in music options over the airwaves, so when vacuous lyrics are foisted on listeners, they become captives under duress. Now, that's pretty extreme, you know, to say that listeners to the radio are somehow captive to it.
Yeah, I would think that young people are getting their music online, not from radio stations any longer. Maybe I'm wrong there. I really don't know the answer to that.
Well, certainly the information technology that we have today allows more options for sourcing music. It's easier to find music than it ever has been.
It's my understanding,
discover new artists.
When you hit 35, that you tend to just sort of stop seeking out new music. This is a tendency not for everybody, but I just don't have that much interest in new music any longer. Sometimes something new will come out, and I'll enjoy it. But there's a new one out where this young gal who's maybe a little chubby, she's singing about that bass.
Oh, that song.
Yeah, it's cute. I like it, but it is bubblegum, right? Mm-hmm. It is. There's nothing to it but bubblegum.
It's scientifically proven, says theantimedia.org, that flexing the intellect can slow cognitive decline, but there has
been
a cultural shift away from stimulating thought in favor of homogenization and living for the moment, and empty radio content is both symptom and reinforcement of that trend. Society is focused on entertainment, materialism, and self-promotion, and when coupled with a need for instant gratification, it's really no wonder we're in such a sorry state. Occasional forays into mindless distraction would be understandable and harmless if they were just forays, but the foundation is faulty due to a sharp decline in quality education at every level. Education has become the highest form of indoctrination, with teachers forced into regurgitating information so their students can pass tests rather than become innovators and original thinkers. And who could blame them? Currently, they're held to the ridiculous system where their performance is ranked and salary determined by how those students perform on standardized tests that are themselves flawed. As Randy Weingarten, the president of the American Federation of Teachers, put it, quote, "This country has spent billions on accountability, not on the improvement of teaching and learning at the classroom level," unquote. An education system based almost solely on taking tests is not only intellectually dimming, it's stressful. Instructors doling out the tests are given a set of instructions for what to do when students vomit on their test booklets. All of this is designed to send students to college, where the situation is perpetuated. According to Catherine Liu, a film and media studies professor at the University of California, quote, "We don't educate people anymore. We train them to get jobs," unquote.
Really? They're doing a terrible job at that. Jobs are... I mean, jobs for young people are diminishing. I was at work at 12 years old. I started work. We had a friend that was working at a local Panera here, and she was having people who were getting their first job in college. I can't even imagine.
Yeah, it's hard. It's shocking. Going on here, a little bit more from theantimedia.org. From a political standpoint, all of this dumbing down makes sense. Indoctrination creates obedience. If music and culture focus on mindless diversion and education lacks, well, education, then people lack the acuity necessary to question the absurdity of the system. Those who manage to liberate themselves from this mold and have the gumption to question official authority will find a cozy spot on the government's watch list. So while we
the government's busy watching everybody.
So while we bemoan our country's lack of intellectual prowess, it isn't by a failure of design. The author of the aptly titled Idiot America, journalist Charles Pierce, thoroughly sums up the issue this way, saying, quote, "The rise of Idiot America today represents, for profit mainly, but also and more cynically, for political advantage in the pursuit of power, the breakdown of a consensus that the pursuit of knowledge is a good. Unfortunately, if the lyric study is a prognostic omen, the epidemic of idiocy will only get worse." So, again, you know, is this some sort of plot by an elite to dumb down the masses, or is it just the way the cookie has crumbled with a just decrepit old system that's based in the 1800s, this education system that hasn't really been updated in any significant manner? Yeah, they got computers now, but the obedience training is still there. And is it
right,
just
bells?
The,
you have to ask permission to use the bathroom, things like that. My son is we keep him home, we homeschool him. He doesn't have to ask anybody to use the bathroom. Mm-hmm. It's ridiculous. I mean, you know, you go to use the bathroom when you need to use the bathroom. I remember this happening multiple occasions in my school career. It's like, no, you can't go to the bathroom. Well, yeah, I guess we all have to be sort of trained on our bladders and that sort of thing. Yeah. But that kind of comes with age.
So if you want to share your thoughts here on the lyrics in songs, it's really hard for them to scrape the bottom of the barrel any further here, but I guess it could get worse. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And still to come tonight, I mentioned, our caller earlier mentioned this adult friend finder thing, this hack that happened. Apparently, millions, their sexual secrets have been exposed. We'll talk about that here in moments. You can share your thoughts on Free Talk Live's Live Sunday Show.
You've helped make Lumber Liquidators North America's largest specialty retailer of hardwood flooring. To say thanks, we've made unbelievable price cuts on top quality floors at our customer appreciation sale. It's your chance to get pre-finished hardwood for just 99 cents and hand-scraped acacia hardwood for $2.99. That's half of what you'd pay at other stores. Plus deals on 400 beautiful floors, including quality laminate from 49 cents and 24-month special financing. You trust our value, we value your trust. So get to the customer appreciation sale today. Visit lumberliquidators.com to find a store near you.
Breathe it in, kid. Every 3 months we install these air handler filters. They're more energy efficient, hold more dust, and are priced to save us more money. And Granger's got close to 3,000 different styles and sizes to choose from, in stock and ready when we need them. I love oxygen, kid. And this facility's got some great AO2. I'm breathing easier just thinking about these air handler filters. Get some today. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgranger.com/filters or stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth slide into a recession or at worst depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. Treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think
you
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make...
Wait.
You wanna come.
Now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free on this live Sunday edition of the program. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. You can Skype in here at username lrn.fm. And if you are online at all, whatever it's on your smartphone or your laptop, your work computer, for instance, if you're online at all, you really need to look into ProXPN for protecting yourself from your very own internet service provider, for instance, or maybe people trying to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets. If you encrypt your internet connection with ProXPN, those people who are snooping on you will not be able to anymore because you're encrypted with ProXPN. Go and get their free software for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, Android devices, and Linux. You go download, get connected with ProXPN, and you'll be protected from the prying and spying. ProXPN.com/FTL. Promo code is FTL50, which gets you 50% off the price of the annual account, meaning that your price point is down to just under $5 per month for this amazing protection over at proxpn.com/FTL. And don't forget, again, code FTL50. With that premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent, and get past regionally blocked websites. So go to proxpn.com/FTL. You can start for free, but when you're ready to upgrade, use code FTL50, and you'll get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. So I mentioned there's the story about the adult dating website that has apparently been hacked, exposing the sexual secrets of millions. This is a story from CNN's Money. More than 3.5 million people's sexual preferences, fetishes, and secrets have been exposed after dating site Adult Friend Finder has been hacked. Already, some of the adult website's customers are being identified by name. Adult Friend Finder asks customers to detail their interests and, based on those criteria, matches people for sexual encounters. The site, which boasts 64 million members, claims to have helped millions of people find traditional partners, swinger groups, threesomes, and a variety of other alternative partners. Now this... Yeah, Adult Friend Finder, I think...
I always just thought it was a scam.
Really?
Well, I'd seen it before. I mean, I...
You just thought it was one of those sites that just wants to take your money, that kind of thing?
Like they'll show you a picture of a naked gal who, you know, pretty clear that in many cases these are sort of professional pictures.
Right.
And they'll say that she lives in some small town.
Near you.
It's near you. And you're like, that seems odd.
Are you sure that's the Adult Friend Finder ads or some, you know, other competitors?
Well, I've heard Adult Friend Finder and then I hear the other stuff and I assume it's all the same thing.
Yeah, I feel like, I mean, I've never been on the site, but Adult Friend Finder, I have seen the advertisements quite a bit on the internet over the years. It feels like they were kind of there first. You know, now everybody talks about Tinder and these other apps that aren't really dating apps. They're really more like hookup apps for sex, essentially.
Yeah.
And I'm sure there are people, I know there are people who have met for dating on Tinder, but it seems like the intent of those apps is... sexual encounters, and that's what Adult Friend Finder is all about, just hooking people up for sexual encounters. And it seems like they were first to market with it, so that's why they've got millions of members here, 64 million. I presume that's international, but that's a lot of people going on here. When signing up for their account, they have to enter their gender and which gender they're interested in hooking up with and what kind of sexual situations they desire. So this is very personal information.
Yeah.
Suggestions that Adult Friend Finder provides for the, quote, tell others about yourself field include, I like my partners to tell me what to do in the bedroom. I tend to be kinky, and I'm willing to try some light bondage or blindfolds. The hack, which took place in March, was first uncovered by independent IT security consultant Bev Robb on her blog Tech Security a month ago, but Robb did not name the site that was hacked. It wasn't until this recent week when England's Channel 4 News reported on the hack that Adult Friend Finder was named as the victim. Included in the exposed personal information are customers' email addresses, usernames, passwords, birthdays, and zip codes, in addition to their sexual preferences. No credit card data has yet been uncovered as part of the hack. But this is a big deal because, you know, if you think about it, there's a lot of, well, not only is it a big deal because people will be able to be identified by their sexual preferences now based on their email address, but also just in general, to release emails and passwords means that you can take that email address and that password, and if you were a hacker type and wanted to do something naughty like this, you could then use that information to try to access that person's account on other websites, because there are a lot of people who will use the same password for multiple websites. And so if they have a password on Adult Friend Finder and it's XYZ, you can go and try that on Google or whatever other website you think this person might have an account at. In fact, if you just look at the email address, you could then go log into that email account, the Hotmail or the Google or whatever, and try that password with that username. And
then you're in pretty good shape.
I'd say odds are good.
That's a bank hack there.
I don't know what... you know, I don't know what the percentage would be of people who would use the same password on all sites, but I bet you it's up to 20%, if not more.
Yeah, I would say it's well
over
that.
If not 50%.
Yeah,
I don't know.
I'd say it's well over that.
Like I said, I don't do that stuff. I'm not interested in hacking people's emails, but this is a good reason right here to use different emails and or different passwords, rather, on all
your websites.
If
you're a human being, well, some people will use the same will use passwords and then sort of modify them based on the website they're on,
okay.
Right? So they'll have initials or something
and then
like that.
The initials of the site or something like that.
So a human being can look at the password and say, huh, it looks like they're using the first three letters of the website and
right.
then adding, their dog Muffy's name, mm-hmm. right? Like, or whatever it is that they do. And so they, you know, when you're talking about a bank hack, it's worth it. To put an individual, a living human being, on that job. If you can, because when you're talking about an email password, getting your email and your password for that, you can lock somebody out of their email and then use that email to go ahead and get into their bank and rechange passwords and then have complete control of their bank account, right?
You can use that email address to change everything, right? Every site sends you, what, you forgot your password, we'll send you an email.
Yep.
And so if you can access the person's email, you've got the keys to pretty much every other site.
That's it,
At the very least, your email address password should be different from your other passwords, at the very least, if you're going to be lazy. You know, there are these websites like LastPass or apps like LastPass that I really like LastPass, and it is a way to have very complicated passwords for things without having to remember them.
Yeah.
So you would remember the one password for LastPass, which hopefully is a decent one, and then you, once you're into LastPass, it will automatically fill in your passwords on other websites.
Sure. It'll just automatically generate them for you, and they'll
be
complicated, weird passwords, and yeah.
So the data is incredibly revealing and potentially damaging. Andrew Arnheimer, a controversial computer hacker who looked through the files, used Twitter to publicly identify adult Friend Finder customers, including a Washington Police Academy commander, an FAA employee, a California state tax worker, and a naval intelligence officer who supposedly tried to cheat on his wife. Arnheimer said, asked why he was doing this, quote, "I went straight for government employees because they seemed the easiest to shame," unquote. Millions of others remain unnamed for now, but anyone can open the files, which remain freely available online, and that could allow anyone to extort adult Friend Finder customers.
Do we is that what we should expect from our government employees, that they're going to somehow be better people than the average individual? Because I feel that way, but I don't know really whether that's a fair thing to feel. I mean, these are just people, right?
No doubt.
Is it that we shouldn't expect that from them, or is it that we just shouldn't give them that much power?
If you want to share your thoughts, join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Or join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. It's the live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. More coming up.
This is a nationwide announcement for consumers owing back taxes to the IRS. The slowdown in the U.S. economy has forced renewed action by the Internal Revenue Service. The IRS is now accepting reduced settlement amounts from qualifying consumers who owe back taxes. If you're eligible, your back tax settlement may be discounted by thousands of dollars. A specially assigned national hotline has been directly routed to Defense Tax Group. Consumers may now call and check their eligibility for a significant tax debt reduction. Financial stability is a major priority during this slow economy, so you're advised to dial this national hotline number now, 800-678-4191. If you owe more than $10,000 in back taxes to the IRS, you may now find significant relief. You could save thousands of dollars if you qualify. Call now and get free vital information and to check your eligibility for a significant tax debt reduction. Call the Defense Tax Group now, 800-678-4191. That's 800-678-4191. 800-678-4191.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, join us here, toll free, 855-450-FREE. Maybe you got caught up in the hack of Adult Friend Finder, big website with 60-something million members, 64 million participants. 3.5 million of them have had their data, their personal information released.
That's a lot of people.
It's a lot of people, and it would be pretty interesting to read through it, I have to say, just to, you know, see what some people's fetishes are and things like that.
It does sound interesting.
Anyway, you apparently the information is available online. I haven't gone to look for it, but I suspect you can find it on sites like the Pirate Bay. I'm just guessing. Like I said, I haven't gone to look for it, but it is out there in multiple locations, and it's not going away. So, you know, if you are on one of these websites and now your privacy, what you thought was your privacy, has been violated by this hack, you may be wondering what you can do, or maybe you're listening to this wondering, well, what can you do to prevent this from happening to you? Because obviously you're not in charge of the security behind these websites. You don't get to control the IT department, whoever it is that the, you know, their people are. You don't know what's going on there, and you have to trust them that they know what the hell they're doing, that they can keep hackers out. Or you can use a throwaway email account. You can, you know, not use your actual email address when you're going to a sensitive website like this, right? So if
banking should probably be done from one email address, and then the other stuff that the other accounts should go through another email address. Does that make sense?
I don't know if I would have a separate account for my bank account necessarily, but I was saying if you wanted to not be found out, you know, if privacy was of the utmost import to you on this, that you would use a throwaway account, an account that is not tied to your name, if you're going to be on one of these adult friend finder sites and are concerned about possibly someone finding out who you don't want to find out.
Certainly not a real stretch in logic there.
All right, so I'll talk more about the hack here in a moment, but first, somebody who knows a thing or two about hackers, Brian Sovereign, has a new video game.
Yeah, Brian Sovereign, he used to be a host here on Free Talk Live, and he has created a new video game. It's with a story like no other. It's full motion video, classic graphics, and pick up and play controls. Hypercronius is a liberty-oriented experience that's not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja. That is the website. It's zog.ninja. Pretty awesome site. I went there and I bought the game myself. You can use Bitcoin, like I did. If you use coupon code FTL, you will get $1 off. Unlike me, who I bought it very early and he didn't have the coupon code out there. Mm. So Free Talk Live listeners can use coupon code FTL, get a buck off when you purchase it. Hypercronius is the name of it, and it's at zog.ninja. I think it's fair to say that this is his, you know, it's a first foray. This is a sampler of what his mind can come up with.
Yeah, he's got a lot in plot for the future if this is commercially successful.
It's certainly available. It certainly lends itself to much more. So zog.ninja.
All right, so there's a little more about the Adult Friend Finder hack where 3.5 million accounts were revealed, everything including their email address and password, as well as their sexual fetishes, zip codes, birthdays. You know how important birthdays are to, getting access to websites.
Yeah, that's a big deal.
This is a lot of information on a lot of people. It's pretty damaging.
You shouldn't even put your real birthday out on the internet, frankly.
There's an argument for that.
I don't. I mean, there's very few things that sort of delineate who you are in the world besides your flesh and blood.
Yeah.
You know, your face, your fingerprints, your birthday. You know, your birth certificate is the birthday is a step towards the birth certificate. Your driver's licenses, you know, driver's license number, social security number. These things are important, and you don't want to have them out there. As you can avoid them as much as you can. I don't give my birthday when people, when doctors feel like they need to have your birthday to do business with you. And rather than tell people like that, look, I'm not going to give you my birthday, I just give them a fake one in order for them to sort of move on. So if I give you the birthday 1-1 and then my birth year, then maybe you'll believe it's my birthday, maybe you won't, but you're getting close enough to my birthday to be able to diagnose whatever you need to know, right? Mm-hmm. Like you have the general range. If I was born 6 months later or 6 months earlier than that, it's not like it's going to change your diagnosis in any way.
Yeah. So the security consultant Rob reported that one person whose information was hacked was a 62-year-old Hispanic male from New Jersey who worked in advertising and has a preference for the sub porno forum. What is that?
I don't know. Submission. Submission.
It's one word.
He likes to get spanked.
That combined with his username and other account details gave Rob enough information to Google him, then find his real name and his social media pages. Mm. The information exposed can be particularly devastating to people living in small towns where they're more easily identified. For example, one person exposed in the hack is a 40-year-old welder from a small Illinois town of a few thousand people. He will, quote, become anybody's slave, unquote, and lied about his age on the site, claiming to be 29. The breach was carried out by a hacker who goes.
That is 39.
goes by the moniker ROR, /RG. In an online hacker forum, he said he blackmailed Adult Friend Finder, telling the site he would expose the data online unless the company paid him $100,000. On the forum, hackers immediately praised ROR/RG, saying they were planning on using the data to attack the victims. Quote, I'm loading these up in the mailer now, / I will send you some dough from what it makes, / thank you, wrote a hacker who goes by Maps. Presumably what he's referencing there and when he says the mailer could be some sort of a mass mailer to send emails to all of the 3.5 million people saying, hey, I've got your information here and I won't reveal it if you give me money, which of course the information's public now, so any amount of hackers could do something like that. Eventually, these people are going to get tired of paying off hackers. If they pay one, that will likely mean another one will come calling.
Yeah, it's just not going to stop.
FriendFinder Networks, the parent company of Adult FriendFinder and other adult sites, including Penthouse, said in a statement that it had just become aware of the breach and is working closely with law enforcement and cyber forensics to figure out what the hell happened. The company says it doesn't yet know the full scope of it, but it promises to work vigilantly, noting that FriendFinder Networks, quote, fully appreciates the seriousness of the issue.
I bet they do.
We cannot speculate further about this issue, but rest assured, we pledge to take the appropriate steps needed to protect our customers if they are affected. Well, I don't know what that would be exactly at this point. You can protect your existing customers further by securing your network a little bit better. But what are you going to do to protect the people who have already been revealed?
We're going to write vigilant-sounding things in press releases.
Yeah, because they weren't going to pay the $100,000 to the ransom. You know, they weren't going to pay that to protect their customers.
Right.
Which, of course, you don't want to do, right?
It wouldn't make a difference anyway, right?
Right. You don't want to do that because who's going to trust this anonymous person? I mean, you're not going to trust the anonymous person who's extorting you to not continue to extorting you, right? Like to, you know, you pay him once. What's to say they're not going to come back and ask for another $100,000?
You better get used to the idea that people know that you'll be a slave for anyone. That's what you need to do.
Pretty much.
And you need to change your passwords on your banking stuff.
Right now.
Right away.
Yeah.
You know what? You need to go change your passwords and your banking stuff anyway.
It doesn't hurt.
Right. Everybody needs to do it. Change your passwords on your email account, too. Just go ahead and do that. Just get something new. It doesn't have to be Bowser123 anymore. Mm-hmm. You can figure out something new. Figure out, numbers and capital letters and these kind of things. You can do it.
With the numbers and capital letters, I would recommend something like a LastPass to keep track of that because there ain't no way I'm going to remember capital L, lowercase q, capital X, 9, caret, open parentheses, bracket, P. You know, that's just not going to – that doesn't fly.
Okay, so it'll be – as I've read recently when it comes to passwords, I agree. Get LastPass and then use one password for LastPass that you can remember. But it shouldn't be short. It should be a long password. It doesn't need to be complicated. It just kind of needs to be long. So think of your favorite book and perhaps you open to page 157. And then you use the first, whatever it says on those pages, you know, to get your favorite book. You circle the page in real life, and then you, you know, type in that first, the first two lines. And then you'll memorize them, I swear, you will. And use the capitalization and everything, the punctuation and all that stuff, and then you'll have a pretty good security system.
Mark is not a security expert. He's not certified by anyone on security, and you may want to do a little more research in good passwords.
What's wrong with that, though?
I don't know, Mark. I mean, capital letters, you know, lowercase, you need to have that, numbers. There's certain things that a complicated password should have.
Longer the better.
A phrase may not necessarily have. You could brute force a phrase. 855-450-FREE. There's more coming up here in moments. Maybe you know a thing or two. You can share that with us.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Hi, Chuck Woolery here. I don't know about you, but I don't like taking pills for minor arthritis pain, and I don't like those patches either. But I've found something that works. Australian Dream Arthritis Pain Relief Cream. It's a great product. Doesn't smell or burn, isn't greasy, and it works. And Australian Dream has an empty jar guarantee. You can use the whole jar. If you're not happy, you get your money back. But I doubt that you'll send it back, because this stuff works. Australian Dream is available at Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, Walmart, Target, and other drugstores and supermarkets everywhere.
In the U.S. alone, a home invasion occurs every 13 seconds. On top of that, the average response time for 911 is over 15 minutes. That just won't cut it. Don't allow yourself or the important people in your life to be victims. When seconds matter, don't be caught stumbling for your firearm. Get the protection you deserve. Get yourself a hidden holster from HiddenHolster.com. It's the original hidden holster. The hidden holster is quick, easy, and convenient. It's versatile enough for the home, workplace, or virtually anywhere else you might need it. Have peace of mind with your firearm close by at all times. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. If you own a firearm, you need a hidden holster. Your protection matters, and self-defense is the best defense. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. The original hidden holster.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
I'm Mark Stevens of the No State Project, and are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're only helping the government. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, Use it, spread it. So get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial toll free to join us here in the remaining moments. 855-450-FREE is our number. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online at freetalklive.com. And if you like what we're doing on Free Talk Live, please support the show by becoming a Free Talk Live amplifier. Go to amp.freetalklive.com. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. And the idea is you send $5 a month into the show via any major credit card through PayPal or Visa or MasterCard. On our website, then you'll get perks, and Free Talk Live will take that $5 and we'll invest it into promoting us to more radio stations and getting more internet listeners to tune in and exposing new people to the ideas of freedom around the globe. So if that's valuable to you and if you enjoy what we do here, please become an amplifier and get the perks like access to the AMP Only call-in lines, the AMP Only Facebook group, and more. All of it over at amp.freetalklive.com, ampamp.freetalklive.com. Jim is on the line in Des Moines. Jim, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Yeah, hi, Mark. Hi, Ian.
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
Thank you. Yeah, one of the things I don't understand is it seems like we're rapidly approaching the point where people can almost count on having their personal information compromised by these sites that are so complacent about security. And what I just can't quite grasp is that, you know, they have a vested interest in protecting this information. You know, it's going to kill business in the end, I would think. Why can't they be more proactive in protecting this information? I mean, I'm not a techie type guy, but I know there has to be ways to do this. I mean, there's secure, you know, banking institutions use secure type methods. Why can't these other sites do this?
It's an excellent question, and we don't know how this hacker got his access, right? So the company isn't revealing. We're talking about the Adult Friend Finder hack with 3.5 million accounts revealed now, with all kinds of details, dirty details about people's sex lives. But, you know, in this case, we don't know what the method of entry was, right? So was it an inside job? You know, as many of these hacks can be, I mean, there's somebody on the inside who's giving them a path in, or they themselves are using the access that they had after they got fired or something like that. Maybe it hadn't been revoked or something. So, you know, who knows what the method was, or maybe it was just some sort of an attack that, you know, exploited a weakness that they didn't even know was there. So there's only so, you know, you can only put up so many walls. You can only put up so many locks, and the person who is most determined we'll be able to overcome that. And we're not just talking about information security, but also physical locks, right? Like, there are people who know how to pick locks, and there are some locks that are harder to pick than others. And, you know, if the person has the drive, whoever the person is that wants the access, if they have the drive and they have the time and they're willing to take the risk, there's no amount of locks and security that can stop the right person, the right perpetrator, if you will.
Right. Another question, can these companies be held liable for the release of this information? Have they ever been sued?
I doubt it. I highly doubt it. I don't know. That's not my legal area of expertise. And it would be interesting to have somebody else answer that question toll free at 855-450-FREE.
I would bet that if when you sign up for their terms of service, that little thing you click that you never read,
we're not liable.
They absolutely absolve themselves of any liability.
I bet you're
right.
I
don't think
that
terms of service has much value from a legal standpoint because nobody reads it.
Well, if it wasn't legally valuable, why would companies bother with it? It must be some
lawyers,
sort of CYA.
Lawyers have families they have to support too.
Jim, anything else you want to share tonight, Jim? Go ahead.
That's just a couple thoughts I had on it. It just seems like it's, you know, it's day after day, it just seems almost ubiquitous anymore. It's and the numbers just keep going up. It's like you hear these hacks, they're in the millions anymore.
Oh, you know?
The numbers are no big deal, right? Like, once you get access, I don't understand why he couldn't get all 64 million. I mean, that's really my question is why, you know, we're talking about a small amount of data here. If we're talking about text, I mean, it's probably no more than a few megabytes, if that, all this information.
Maybe he's holding the rest.
I wonder if they might intentionally compartmentalize it just in case there is a hack.
Could be.
It's a good idea.
That could be, or Mark could be right as well, that maybe he's just keeping the other 60 million of them close to his chest.
for the
could
moment.
Could be. Maybe we'll hear about that in the near future. Anyway, enjoy the show.
Thanks,
Thank
Jim.
You.
Appreciate your call tonight. Let's talk to John in Nevada in Carson City. John, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hi. Ian's right. LastPass is a great way to manage your password, and I just wanted to give people a tip on one way to make a really strong passphrase for LastPass.
Okay, please.
And if you look up Diceware on the internet, if you Google it, D-I-C-E-W-A-R-E, it's a pencil and paper system that anyone can use, pencil, paper, and dice, where you roll dice a series of times to select random words from a really long list.
Mm-hmm.
And what this does is you can select, a passphrase of 4 words, 5 words, as many words as you want, and you can know mathematically, like, exactly how strong that is. And, 5 or 6 words would be a very strong and secure passphrase. And if you went to 7 or 8, then that would be as strong as Bitcoin itself.
Wow. Okay, so Mark was right then when he said the long phrase would be very, very good for a password.
If it's random, I actually can't recommend exactly what Mark was saying.
Uh-huh.
It's pretty random. When you pick, like...
People are really bad at this, Mark, and what you think is random is not necessarily as random as you think.
Okay.
But with Diceware, you know it's random. You know, you really have a mathematical proof of it. So, and Ian's right, don't trust everything people say, but if you check this out, you'll see that cryptographers will say that Diceware is really sound.
Now, if you're using dice, you're getting around the randomizer problems, right, with computers, meaning that a random number
a
computer isn't always random?
Exactly. You don't have to worry about if someone is recording your random number generator or if there's a flaw in it that makes it not random. The dice are random, and there's no record of what you did
Interesting.
That gets online.
Well,
so,
dice are sort of random. Let me ask you some questions about this and how it's set up. So you're much more likely to roll a 6 or a 7 on a pair of dice than you are to roll snake eyes or double sixes, because there is only one way to get to mm-hmm. snake eyes. That's a 1 and a 1. There are many ways to get to 6 or 7, which is that you can roll a 2 and for 7, you can roll a 2 and a 5, a 3 and a 4, a 1 and a 6.
Well, I can quickly explain what you do. You roll for each word you're generating, you roll 6 dice. All right? And so then you get 6 numbers, each, 1 through 6. So you put them in the order you rolled them or whatever order you arranged the dice. Then you take that 6-digit number, and that's an index into a very large list of numbers.
Okay.
So that's how it works. And mathematically, you can know exactly how strong your password is. And they're very strong once you get up to 5 words. And it's easy to remember. It's easier than you would think to remember a 5-word password of random words.
Yeah, it's not that hard.
John, thanks for your call tonight. Appreciate the info here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So John says he also recommends the LastPass app. I imagine there are some competitors to LastPass. And I feel like, I can't say for sure. I've done enough research to know for sure. But I feel like the LastPass people are encrypting the passwords, and meaning that they don't have access to them, because obviously that would be devastating, right?
That would be huge.
If LastPass gets hacked, would that put everybody's passwords in jeopardy? Not if they're storing them encrypted, and not if your password somehow decrypts the encryption, I guess is what I'm saying.
Right.
So I'm not a security expert, but I suspect the security people have, audited LastPass.
Everything I've ever heard about LastPass is good, so...
Because that if there's vulnerability there, they're going to get hammered, right?
Yeah.
Like, LastPass is going to get hammered. That is a huge target, in the same way that if Bitcoin were hackable, somebody would have done that by now. LastPass has been around for several years at this point.
Yeah, the guys on our show, Johnson and Brian Sovereign, they're not going to recommend these things. They're going to look
into it. Does Brian recommend LastPass?
I know that he knows that I use it, and so therefore
he hasn't said stop.
Yeah, right. Okay. He didn't say stop, so I consider that a recommendation.
Yeah, absolutely true. So, you know, you got to take your security seriously out there. Nobody else is going to take it seriously for you, and, you know, obviously we've given you some tools here on Free Talk Live. ProXPN is a great way to encrypt your data connection. LastPass isn't an advertiser, but maybe they should be, Mark. Let's look into that one.
What? How much money do they make?
I don't know.
See, this is the thing. It's just,
yeah, because it's a free app. So I don't know how many their people pay. I actually paid for their app for the phone though, so they have a LastPass app for your phone, and I did buy that app. But the one for the web browsers is free. So yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I wonder how much companies like that can spend in advertising. If you know, where do they get their revenue?
Yeah. All right. Well, anyway, there are all kinds of other cool things that you can do to increase your privacy. And again, if you're using a website like Adult Friend Finder. And, you know, you've got your own personal information in there. Maybe now's the time to go and change out your email address to something that's a little more throwaway. But then again, how difficult that'll make things. You could always make another fake Gmail account, right? Because Gmail doesn't check any of your information. You can easily create a username there that is not you. That's not associated with everything else you do online. So consider that. And we'll talk to you again tomorrow night when I believe Dave Ridley's going to be joining us.
That'd be great.
As co-host. Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, May 24th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.13 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,206 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $240. Antiwar.com reports earlier this week, the Justice Department said that if there is no extension of Section 215 of the USA Patriot Act in place, they'd start winding down the NSA surveillance program this weekend. Bluff or not, they better start doing so because there will be no extension. The Senate went into recess Saturday afternoon after a pair of procedural votes aimed at extending the program both fell short of the 60 votes needed. With the Senate and House in recess, there's almost no chance of renewal of Section 215 before June 1st, when it formally expires. The first vote, aimed at an unamended version of the USA Freedom Act, which the House had already passed, fell short by just 3 votes, with 57 voting for and 42 against. The act was a watered-down reform bill that had been so watered down, many argued it actually enhanced government surveillance authority. The second vote, a 2-month extension of Section 215, aimed at just buying some time to get around threats of filibusters, also failed by a vote of 54 to 45. The House had not voted on this before recess, and Representative Justin Amash from Michigan claimed assurances that they would not attempt to rush through a recess voice vote over the weekend, even if the Senate passed it. The NSA telephone surveillance program allowed them to collect metadata about Americans' phone calls, though earlier this month, an appeals court ruled that Section 215 of the USA Patriot Act did not actually allow them to do this. In spite of ruling the program illegal, the court did not order that it be halted, and everyone was still